following NCAA bowl game is a feature presentation of Mizzlou Television Sports. From Anaheim, California, we welcome you to the fourth annual Freedom Bowl, where tonight, Arizona State plays host to the United States Air Force Academy. The 1987 Freedom Bowl is being brought to you by the Pabst Brewing Company, makers of Pabst Blue Ribbon and Olympia Premium Beers. By 3M, worldwide sponsor of the 1988 Olympic Games. 3M, supporting the dream. By Old Spice, fast-track deodorant. It blocks odor better. And by GM. GM meets your challenge now with quality, selection, value. Good evening, everybody, from Anaheim, California. On a beautiful evening, it's the fourth annual Freedom Bowl. I'm Ray Scott. Happy holidays to you. By my side, and our analyst for tonight's game, a former great receiver at Notre Dame and the Los Angeles Rams, and now a veteran sportscaster in his own right, delighted to have Jack Snow here. Jack, it appears that, except for an official announcement from Ohio State University, John Cooper, the ASU head man, is going to Ohio State. We understand that announcement will be made very shortly. What effect do you think that will have on his team this evening?
Well, Ray, to be honest with you, I think it will have effects on two types of people. The senior ball players, they were not recruited by Cooper. So in essence, you know, they're going to be sorry that he's going, that's true, but they're going to want to get this ball game under their belt, go out with a win, and then look forward to a professional career. The guys that are going to hit kind of hard are the underclassmen, your freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, because they were recruited by Cooper, and they're going to be quite sad to see him go.
On the basis of the outstanding season by the Sun Devils last year, John Cooper was selected Coach of the Year. Now we have Fisher DeBerry, the Air Force Academy head coach, who was Coach of the Year 1985. He coaches a wishbone attack. What do you think Arizona State can do against that wishbone attack in view of the fact that they seldom see that type of an offense?
Well, they seldom see it, but they have seen it twice this year, against the University of Pacific, which runs the wishbone, and then again against the University of Arizona, which runs the run and shoot. But there are elements of the wishbone in that attack. What's going to have to happen tonight for Arizona State defensively is they're going to have to shut down that fullback number one, force the quarterback to pitch that ball out to his trailing back, and then make sure that they have that trailing back or that eye back or that tailback, make sure somebody is on him to try and bring him down.
The third member of our broadcast team will be on the field this evening to keep us up to date on what transpires down there. And our colleague on the field is Brock Rote. Brock.
Thank you, Ray. Well, now that you've covered the information off the field, let's cover it on the field. We've got a classic David against Goliath story out here, but with a bit of a twist. A twist because David, in the case of Air Force, has come in with a better record, 9-3, whereas Goliath, the bigger and stronger Arizona State team, has a record and an average season of 6-4-1. Although they're both postseason bowl teams, they come in with different records. Of course, we've got a team Air Force with a 9-3 record that was led by Dee Dowitz, number 6, a great quarterback, standout for Air Force this season, rushing for over 1,300 yards, setting a new NCAA record for quarterbacks, but he will not be in the game for Air Force because of a broken wrist. He will be substituted by backup quarterback Steve Letnich. He is also a good quarterback, a good runner, but a better passer. On the other side of the line with ASU, we've got a quarterback situation that's been up in the air all year. ASU has basically started three different quarterbacks. Tonight they're going to go with Daniel Ford, though. We'll be back with a ball game right after these messages. We'll be right back.
We're back at the Freedom Bowl. Hello, everybody. I'm Dwayne Dow. And now the matchups. Brought to you by the Pabst Brewing Company, makers of Pabst Blue Ribbon, Hams, and Olympia Premium Beers. Now, let's take a look at those Freedom Bowl matchups as the Air Force Academy takes on Arizona State. Coach Fisher DeBerry's 1987 Air Force football team will be remembered for its record-breaking offense and its defensive superstar. 6 feet, 6 inches tall, 260 pounds, defensive tackle Chad Hennings, a first-team All-America, as well as being selected winner of the coveted Outland Trophy. This season, the senior notched an incredible 24 quarterback sacks. All-Western Athletic Conference senior linebacker Rip Bergwald led the team with 128 tackles. On offense, Air Force had the second-best rushing offense in the nation, averaging 386 yards per game. Starting fullback Quinton Roberts rushed for at least 84 yards each of the final four games. Junior Anthony Roberson was the team's all-purpose yardage leader. He also scored 10 touchdowns. The Air Force, making its fifth bowl appearance in 6 years. Arizona State, the Sun Devils, under the guidance of third-year head coach John Cooper. They have battled their way to a third straight bowl appearance here at the Freedom Bowl. The Sun Devils were led to a record of 6 wins, 4 losses, and a tie by two-time All-America guard Randall McDaniel, one of the nation's truly great linemen. The Arizona State offense features the talents of split end Aaron Cox, one of the best ever to play for the Sun Devils. Tailback Darrell Harris was the man Coach Cooper counted on when the ground game was the call. Tackle Sean Patterson and cornerback Eric Allen spearhead the Sun Devil defense. Allen picked off 8 passes during the 1987 season to rank second in the Pacific 10 Conference. The Arizona State Sun Devils against the Air Force Academy when we return.
Air Force Academy won the toss, and contrary to what a lot of teams have done this season, they did not defer to the second half. They want the football. That means we'll see quarterback Steve Letnich, fullback Quinton Roberts. Remember now, this is a wishbone. You won't see a flanker up there. Two halfbacks, Anthony Roberson, Albert Booker. Wide receiver, Tyler Barth. The tight end will be Frank Martini. Quickness, that's what this offensive line has. Starting from the left side, Jim Payne, Ray Garcia, Blake Geddes, Dave Klatke, Jeff Johnson, the interior offensive lineman. Now, defensively, we expect to see Trace Armstrong, Mark Duckins at nose guard, Sean Patterson and Rick Zumwalt.
Yeah.
double back. That's terminology used by the coaching staff at Arizona State. And then the defensive backfield, Eric Allen, the great leader of that defensive secondary, Eric Crawford, Robbie Boyd, Jeff Malstead, Zendejas of that famed Zendejas family will be kicking off. Boy, what a family of talented kickers, Jack.
It seems like it's a never-ending progression of great Zendejas players, and they're all excellent kickers.
Okay. Deep will be Roberson, number 20, and Faison, number 27. And here we go, the fourth annual Freedom Bowl. From the six-yard line. To the 25. Arizona State. The first hit of the game belongs to Rick Zumwalt, who will be a starting defensive player for the Sun Devils. First and 10, Air Force Academy. 25-yard line. Now, Steve Letnich, the quarterback, number 14, was the starter at the start of the season. Things didn't go very well early in the Wyoming game, and then he was replaced by Dee Dowell. And there, number 97, one of the two co-captains for the Sun Devils, Sean Patterson, either thought he saw movement or else was just a little too anxious.
I think we're going to have an offside call on the right guard, Ray. David Hatke may have been jumping just a tad too soon.
Uh-huh.
False start of the offense.
False start. Five-yard penalty, first and 15, Air Force Academy. Now, apparently the messenger system will be used by the Air Force Academy. That was out wide to the left. Steve Sims. About 3 yards and in the grasp of Sean Patterson. Who else? Albert Booker, number 21, is a junior from Inman, South Carolina.
Not a lot of size on this Air Force Academy offensive unit. The offensive line averaging about 250. You look at Albert Brooks' stats, 72 rushes, 6.4 yards a carry, and 7 TDs. Outstanding average per carry.
Gain of 4, second down 11, Air Force 24. We're just underway. The Freedom Bowl from Anaheim. The fake went to the fullback. And the cornerback, Eric Crawford, number 39 for the Sun Devils, stayed home and kept that run by Booker from gaining a first down.
That's why you defend the wishbone. You do that very well. Arizona State did that extremely well on that last play. Eric Crawford coming up and playing Albert Booker, the outside pitch man for the Air Force Academy. That's the way you draw it up on the board. That's the type of execution that ASU is going to need to slow these guys down.
Third down, a bit more than 5. Air Force 30. Quinton Roberts, and I would have to say in this opening series, Jack, that the Sun Devils apparently have been under some pretty good coaching in trying to stop that wishbone.
They've done a good job. Larry Marmee, the defensive coordinator and the inside linebacker's outstanding job of defending the Air Force so far in this first series.
Nathan LeDuc is back. Blasey, and the Sun Devils will have the football. We'll return to the Freedom Bowl in Anaheim right after these messages. Force Academy fans outnumber Sun Devil followers here this evening. We'll tell you why shortly. Meanwhile, Sun Devils, first possession, their own 25. Daniel Ford is the quarterback. Behind him, Williams the fullback, Harris the tailback. It would seem to me that we might get at least a partial answer here this evening. Can the quickness of an Air Force Academy somehow overcome the size and strength of the Sun Devils, who have Ford, Williams, a fullback, Harris, the tailback, Johnson, Tony Johnson, that is, starting at the one wideout spot, the flanker, Aaron Cox, their number one wide receiver, and Gary Knutson in the tight end. Second down, 8, Sun Devil 27. No score from Anaheim. The 45-yard line. Now, Aaron Cox, despite somewhat average statistics, 38 receptions, he's a big league receiver. Underwood, McDaniel, Sperling, Kalis, Kirby. McDaniel and Kalis have been described by some as maybe the best pair of offensive guards in the country.
Outstanding offensive line, and to be honest with you, Todd Kalis may not be that far behind Randall McDaniel as you look at Aaron Cox, one of the fine receivers in the all of American football, all of college football today. Just does not have the stats to back it up, though. He's an outstanding receiver.
It was a false move by the tight end Knutson, and that's going to cost the Sun Devils 5 yards. After an 18-yard gain from Ford to Aaron Cox. Let's identify these officials. We're going to hear from our referee right now.
Dead ball. Ball start.
His microphone is working. He is being Dean Kramer. Here's what happened to cause that 5-yard penalty.
You can see Ford, he's audibilizing right now. You saw Knutson at the far end, just on the other side of the yard marker, jump offside. He beat the snap count penalty, ASU.
First and 15, good protection. He's going for Aaron Cox, but it's overthrown by quite a margin. Defending was Gary Kilmer, the right cornerback. Now the defense, the much talked about and property so, Chad Hennings, John Steed, Dan Mullins. That's the front threesome. Outside backers, Hughes on the one side, then Larson and Bergwald inside. Bergwald, the leading tackler for the Air Force, and then Gladney. With a secondary of Alco, Kilmer, Gant, and Mathis. Second down 15, Sun Devils, their own 40. Early first quarter, first goal. Three wide receivers now, just the one running back. Hitting there was Darryl Sumrall, number 89, a junior defensive lineman from Mason, Ohio.
Again, we go back to the point we made about the Arizona State, the size differential. As you look at their offensive line, they average 280 pounds from tackle to tackle. And by golly, their running backs, they're 203 pounds average. So they've got a big offensive unit.
Other than Kramer, a rundown of the rest of the officials. It's a third down, 12 from the ASU 43. Garrett is lined up as a tight end on the right side. Here comes a blitz. Williams picked it up. Flag down. Usually that flag dropped where it was means one of two things, either holding or some penalty involving the quarterback.
Exactly, and I think you may be right, Ray. It looks like it may be a holding call against Arizona State.
Holding on the offense.
It was a holding call. This will be declined. It brings on the punter. And receiving the punt will be one of their wide receivers, Tyler Barth, a senior from Barrington, Illinois.
Holding.
Mike Shue is one of the finest punters in college football, averaging over 42 yards per punt. And the majority of them inside the opponent's 20-yard line.
He's done a great job of dropping that ball down inside the 20, giving their defense excellent field position throughout the year.
Pretty good hang time. Barth at the Air Force 20. Very, very good coverage there. 37-yard punt, 2-yard return. Air Force second possession coming up from their own 22 in a scoreless game. We'll return after these words from your local station. Academy usually uses just one wide receiver, either Barth, number 25, also a punt returner, or Steve Senn, number 83, and they're messengers. They'll alternate on almost every play. The running backs, 21, Booker, 20, Roberson, 33, Roberts, the fullback, in this wishbone attack, and the quarterback, Steve Lechnich, number 14. Now that's Barth out to the left. Thank you. receiver was open, but a pass a little bit too low. The coverage was by Robbie Boyd, the strong safety.
Arizona State with good coverage on the outside and inside. Robbie Boyd in there along with Eric Crawford who had outside containment. Tyler Barth, who the pass was intended for, the leading receiver for the Air Force this year, only 14 receptions.
He played despairingly in that opening game. Then was replaced by Dallas, who unfortunately cannot play because of injury. Oh, about a 5-yard pickup to the 26-yard line. Incidentally, to point out the scarcity of passing by the Air Force Academy, mainly, I guess you can say because their running has been so very impressive, is the fact that they average only 57 yards a game through the air.
Yeah, they don't throw a lot. They only average 9 passes a game, and that's not a whole lot, but their running attack has been so well this year, establishing a new school career record for total yards on the ground. Just a very, very good running football team.
Now, they split out the tight end to the right, and Martini, in addition to the player wide to the left, and once again, that wishbone is defended very well as Quentin Roberts is able to get just a yard or so, and the ever-present number 97, Sean Patterson, was in on yet another tackle. It is fourth down. And once again, Chris Blasey punting to Nathan LeDuc. Cox is a punt returner, but it's LeDuc this time. Pretty good hang time. LeDuc, a freshman. And the Air Force Academy covers extremely well. The Sun Devils must start from their 34-yard line. We have no score here in the early going. With 10-11 left to play in the first quarter in the Freedom Bowl. And we'll be back after these messages. We've had just one first down in this game so far. That recorded by the Sun Devils on a pass from Ford to Cox. Now the two wide receivers are out to the left from 1st and 10 ASU from the Sun Devil 34-yard line. Let's go. Ford, good opening. Channing Williams, good speed. 40. A gain of about 8 yards for Channing Williams. Safety Mario Mathis made the defensive play for the Air Force Academy. Williams has good speed.
Channing Williams, 217-pound senior fullback. He wants to go inside. He dips inside, gets by one of the linebackers, Kevin Hughes, bounces to the outside. Mario Mathis comes up, has the angle, but takes him down. One thing about Channing is you get another shot at this would be a good shot right here. Now watch him straight. Gets breaks one tackle. Now watch him. He's going to try and get outside, but Mario Mathis comes in, corrals him. An outstanding running back, big, strong, fast.
Gain of 8. Close to the first down. Number 87 getting up. I'm sure that Air Force fans recognize Ed Hennings immediately. And this is a first down. First down number 2 for the Sun Devils. The Air Force has not been able to move the sticks yet. Also in on that play was Rip Bergwall, the leading tackler for the Falcons. First and 10, ASU just shy of their own 45. 9:50 to play first quarter. Tony Johnson is wide right. Cox is split to the left. First down. Tony Johnson. Good pass. Finally moved out of bounds by Craig Palko. Did he force him deep, Jack, and then come back to the ball?
I'll tell you what, as you look at his receptions, they're only 13, but look at his average, 18.2 yards, and he's kind of a backup. He's going to run an out route. This is a good pass by Daniel Ford. Has not been consistent all season long, but throws an excellent pass here. Tony Johnson, who beats Greg Palko, comes back to make the catch. Now Palko has got to knock him out of bounds. Otherwise, a big, big gain for Arizona State. Nice execution between quarterback and receiver.
22-yard pickup, first and 10 Sun Devils. 34-yard line, well, between the 33 and 34 of the Air Force. There goes Williams, but not very far. Who do you think has him? Chad Hennings. His
statistics are amazing this season. The second leading tackler, a down lineman, 24 quarterback sacks, forced 5 fumbles, and recovered 3 of them. What else?
Well, he does everything defensively, and you're looking right there at Kevin Hughes, the junior linebacker. There's the offense for Arizona State, but Hennings, you're right. He does a lot of things so well. I like that guy right there we just saw, big fullback 44, Channing Williams. He's an outstanding running back in my estimation. I like him.
No gain, second down 10, Air Force 33. Little draw. There goes Williams. Next up about 7 in the grass.
Randall Gladney coming in there making that stop on that one, Ray. Did a good job. Otherwise, he's off to the races again.
Well, the sophomore from Marina, California saved a possible touchdown.
Channing Williams, 118 carries, almost 700 yards, averaging 5.9 yards a pop. Outstanding for a fullback.
It was ruled that he was down at the 28-yard line. Third down, 5, ASU. No score. First quarter, 8:22 left in the period. Been a misread. Cox broke to the outside, passed thrown to the inside, or perhaps his arm was hit there by Kevin Hughes. He had good penetration.
I think that's the key. He had plenty of time, but I'll tell you what happened. At the very end, Kevin Hughes comes in from the outside. You're getting a good shot from the end zone. Kevin Hughes will come from the outside. Watch for it as he gets, boom, he gets by one guy. Now he sets up to throw that ball, and here comes 56. Kevin Hughes in from the outside, who disrupts the timing between quarterback and receiver.
Now, Allens and Dejos. 13 of 15 field goals, trying a 45-yarder, and no, wide to the left. So the Air Force Academy blunts the attack, and John Cooper is not happy with what transpired either in that series or that particular play.
Well, he's upset about the field goal attempt. He wanted a good snap, and he said, get that ball up in the air. There he is, John Cooper, 1985 National Coach of the Year.
I think that should be 86 Coach of the Year.
I think you're right.
Yeah, Fisher DeBerry was the Coach of the Year, 1985. So we still have a scoreless game. We're not quite up to the midway point of the first quarter. Air Force Academy, which has yet to record a first down, has the ball first and 10 at the Falcons 28-yard line. That makes the quarterback. Keeper. Good gain on first down. Just a little bit more than 5 yards.
Interesting guy. Letnitz talked with him at the luncheon we had the other day, and I asked him his biggest asset as you look at Fisher DeBerry sending in the play. Now, there, that's 86th National Coach of the Year. I think he's the 85 Coach of the Year.
But yes, he was Coach of the Year. That's important.
Exactly. Both these guys. He's an outstanding guy, Fisher DeBerry. Class act.
Second down, 5.5. Air Force 33. Did he give to the fullback? No, he still has it. There goes Letnitz. 50, 40, 30. The cornerback after a 40-yard run by Steve Letnitz.
Watch Letnitz fake it to his fullback right here, Quentin Roberts. He pulls it back inside. There's no containment. We talked about that at the beginning of the show. Nobody's there to make him pitch that ball. Now he's off to the races, and he said Tuesday at the luncheon that he wasn't very fast, but I'll tell you what, he did a great job of running. Look at it from ground level. This is super. He gets a couple of good blocks right there from his offensive line. Splits the seam. He gets up into the seam. Now he's into the secondary. Again, not great speed, but good enough to get a lot of yards.
At the 27-yard line of the Sun Devils and breaking a couple of tackles before being brought down. New running back has just checked in there. Greg Johnson, sophomore, Greg. San Antonio, Texas.
Sean Patterson.
Steve Letnitz, Valparaiso, Indiana.
6 foot, 185 pounds sophomore. Remember, that guy started the very first game of the year against Wyoming, so he is used to being the number one quarterback because he was in that role coming out of spring and starting the season.
Second down, 7. Sun Devil 24-yard line for the Air Force. Sun is wide left. The fullback, Quentin Roberts. Within about, very close to first down. I'd say less than a yard away, and third down coming up. Now, The first two series, the Sun Devils appeared to defense just about anything that the Wishbone was doing. What happened on that 40-yard run from a defensive point of view?
Well, what happened was the linebacker or the defensive end, the man assigned to take the quarterback, he was blocked. A good job by Air Force, by one of the offensive backs or one of the down linemen, got a good block. Let's see if we can pick it up right now. He's going to fake to the fullback, Sean Patterson. There he is, 59, I believe, is or 57. Might have been Stacy Harvey or Drew Metcalf who's responsible. Comes in and makes that tackle right there. That's the last time was 35, I believe, for Arizona State. Rick Zumwalt.
Zumwalt made the last.
Right, time. Right. But getting back to your point, if that man assigned to the quarterback does not make him pitch the ball, the quarterback is told, you just keep it, take up, turn up field, and run with it.
That's almost like, in certain stages, a man-for-man defense, is it not?
Well, the hardest thing about playing against a wishbone is if you're a defensive player, you have got to do your assignment, which oftentimes means I'm not going to be around the ball. I've got to take this guy even though the ball is going somewhere else. And it's hard to teach young men that because they all want to be around the football. They want to get in on that tackle. They want to hit somebody.
A key third down. Less than a yard to go for a first down. Just short of the 17-yard line of Arizona State. No score. 6:21 left to play first quarter. Johnson, he's making a change. Leftwich keeps it. It appears he has enough for the first down. Just around the 16-yard line.
Get a shot of the Air Force offensive line. Let's see if they move the defensive line of Arizona State. Looks pretty good right there. They do move them back, at least try and stop them, stand them up, and let that quarterback, Steve Letchnitz, find the little hole and pop through it. A good job by Drew Metcalf coming in there and holding it for not much of a game, but enough for the first down.
Birmingham, Alabama's Trace Armstrong, number 93, made the tackle, but not enough, not soon enough to prevent a first down. So it's first and 10, Air Force, 16-yard line. Oh, there's it. Albert Booker. Junior, running back from Inman, South Carolina. Short yardage. Zumwalt again made the defensive play, number 35 for ASU. And we have an Air Force player down. And he'll receive attention here with 5:42 left to play in the first quarter. And the player shaken up is the fullback, Quinton Roberts, a senior running back from Lansing, Michigan. Meanwhile, John Cooper, after many days of not knowing what was going to happen, it's very obvious now that an announcement will be made by Ohio State within the next few hours that John Cooper has been offered and has accepted the head coaching job occupied by Earl Bruce.
Quinton Roberts, the fullback you see coming off the field. Now, he is the fullback who normally is a very big guy. He's only 181 pounds. So he takes a beating game in and game out. Very, very durable, very tough individual.
Second down, 6 Air Force, 13-yard line of ASU. Andy Smith is now the fullback. This is Letnitz, and there's the pitch. And there's a touchdown by Greg Johnson. That was, it seemed to me, Jack, about as well executed as you can make that play.
Well, it was just super. And again, just fantastic execution on the part of the Air Force Academy. Eric Allen, the defensive corner for Arizona State, got caught in the bind. He didn't know whether he should come in and take that quarterback or whether he should take the trail back, Greg Johnson. He decided to take a move. By that time, the ball was pitched out. Touchdown for the Air Force.
So the Air Force scores first to take a 6-0 lead. 5:18 to play, first quarter. Now the snapper will be Kevin Bullard, the holder, Eric Olson, and Steve Yarbrough, who has been perfect this season. 30 for 30 extra points, make it 31 for 31. And so the underdog Air Force Falcons have jumped off to a 7-0 lead and will return to Anaheim right after these messages. This is how the score became 6-0.
Watch Steve Letnitz now. He's got his man isolated. Greg Johnson dips inside to draw in Eric Allen, 25. There he is. Allen's caught between the rock and a hard spot. He pitches the ball out to Greg Johnson. Touchdown, Air Force. Another good shot. This would be a great shot right here. Now watch him as he gets outside. Now watch Letnitz. Now watch him dip inside like he's going to keep the ball right there. Meantime, Allen commits himself, pitches the ball out to Johnson. There's nobody on Johnson. Touchdown.
7 plays, 72 yards, all on the ground. And Greg Johnson gets the score, followed by the extra point by Yarbrough. Yarbrough will now handle the kickoff chores. Rockroat, we haven't had a chance to hear from you yet.
Well, basically, Ray, a big effect is how the ground looks right now. Take a look at underneath me, how much mud there is. We had plenty of rain here at Anaheim yesterday. The tarp was put on the field, but it is still muddy, especially on the outside near the edge of the field, especially where Letnich made his pitch and made the touchdown. So obviously, the advantage goes to the defense because the offense has the advantage because they know where they're going. The defense doesn't, and it's a slick grass out here right now. Back to you.
Okay, Rock. Yarbrough will kick off to either Vic Cahoon, number 31, or David Winsley, number 37. And there is Johnson. Greg Johnson, Tulsa, Oklahoma, junior. I'm sorry. That's Tony Johnson. Greg Johnson, the sophomore from San Antonio, Texas. So the Air Force is on the board. Yarbrough's kick will be taken by Winsley from the 15-yard line of ASU. That hit for the Air Force was Michael Voljack. I hope I pronounced his name correctly. V-E-T-A-N-C-E. That's one name I forgot to ask about. I'm going to hopefully say it correctly when I say Betance. But he made the tackle, however pronounced. First down, Sun Devils are on 29.
He did a fine job. However you pronounce it, it's immaterial. He just made a big, big play. Outstanding job for Air Force.
Sun Devils send Tony Johnson to the right and Aaron Cox, their number one receiver, to the left. Daniel Ford, a quarterback. Harris, 12, the tailback. Williams, 44, the fullback. First down. Tony Johnson. And forward progress will be the 35, gain of 6, hit made by Greg Palko, the cornerback, and Mike Gant, listed as the Falcon. I believe I can refer to him also as the strong safety.
I think you're absolutely right. And it's neat to see some of the different terminology that the different schools have for key players. In their defensive system for Air Force, the strong safety is the Falcon back, which means he's got to come up and really do a good job against the run with Mike Gant.
Second down, 4.
The all everything, the Outland Trophy winner, defensive lineman with 46 sacks in his career at the Air Force Academy. Defensive end, and watch him come down the line, number 87. Pick him up. There he is. He fights off a block. It looked like he fought off the block of Randall McDaniel. He comes to the outside, tackles Channing Williams, takes him down. Big, big play for Chad Hennings.
Loss of half yard, third down, and just about 5. Sun Devils 34. And the Air Force 7-0. Late first quarter. For a first down to Knutson, the tight end at the 44-yard line. Great patience, I thought, shown by Ford that time, waiting for that tight end to clear.
Well, that's what one of the things that Cooper said about Ford. Sometimes he'll look brilliant and sometimes a little less than brilliant. But on that last play, Daniel Ford stayed in the pocket nicely. He sent two receivers, one deep and squared in and one short and square in. And the short man was Gary Knutson, the tight end. Daniel Ford waited for him. There he is right there, 17 catches, averaging 10.2 yards a catch, which is a pretty good stat for a tight end.
Chris Garrett, 85, and Aaron Cox, 84, both out to the right. First and 10 play for ASU. Here's Harris. Good job done by that defensive line. And again, Chad Hennings.
Excellent job. There's Hennings, 87. Watch him hit in right there. He keeps going. He never loses his feet. Comes right down the line of scrimmage. He's pursuing from behind. The ball carrier tries to cut back. And what do you know? There he is. Chad Hennings right there to make the tackle.
Elberon, Iowa.
Ray, can you see him in the cockpit of a fighter pilot at 6'5", 260?
Let me tell you, for what he's done for this football team, they might build him his own plane.
Whoa.
No gain last play. Second down, 10. ASU 44-yard line.
Second down, 10.
About 8 yards, but let's see what the penalty is all about.
We may have another hole. We may have another hole against Arizona State, one of the offensive linemen.
Bergwald and Gladney teamed up to make the tackle. There it is. Holding penalty. I'd have to think.
We're going to get a shot of Randall McDaniel, the quick guard. There he is, 62 on the left. Let's watch him. Are the hands in? Are the shoulders in? Everything looks fine right there, but he's got that jersey with his right hand. Yes, definite call, holding call. Good job by the official.
10-yard penalty.
So after that 10-yard mark off, Ford at this stage is 4 of 7 for 55 yards. Chris Garrett, number 85, joins the huddle as the messenger as John Cooper is on the phones with his people upstairs. Second down 20 from the ASU 34. 2:43 to play first quarter. We just seen one score, 7-0 Air Force. Been suspended and then 24 hours later returned to the team, number 85, a 24-yard gain and a first down.
Arizona State running out of a slot formation with Chris Garrett in the slot on the left. He runs a corner route after Aaron Cox clears out. A nice catch, 1 foot inbounds. Here's a good shot. This is a good shot here. There's a slot. Cox on the outside will run a streak and clear it out. Puts number 8, Gary Kilmer, in the bind. 85, Chris Garrett cuts it off, makes a nice catch. 18 catches, 199 yards, and 4 TDs.
And a first down this time at the 42-yard line of the Air Force. And first down. There's Tony Johnson, close to a first down, a gain of about 9 to the 33-yard line. And Ford so far, Jack, is throwing just about as well, I think, as he's thrown all year.
I've seen him a couple of times this year, and he has been a little sporadic, but you're right, Ray. There's no question tonight. His timing is down nicely. He's releasing that ball in good fashion. He's hitting his receivers right in the chest, right in the numbers with the football. So far, so good for the junior quarterback, Daniel Ford.
Sun Devils have had one scoring opportunity, but Zendejas missed by quite a margin, a field goal attempt of 45 yards. It is second and one at the Air Force 33. First down run of 13 yards to the 21-yard line of the Air Force, where Mike Gant, the strong safety, had to make the tackle.
I tell you, a great job of blocking. Number 12, watch number 12, the left of your screen. Watch the block he gets on 86, Dan Mullins. Right there, whammo, he takes him down, and that's the key. Channing bounces outside. He gets a good block from one of his outside receivers in the slot formation. Heck of a job. Now watch 12. Now watch him. He'll make his shift. There's Channing Williams. 12 gets a good block on Dan Mullins. Now he'll try to get to the outside. He does get by 18, Mario Mathis, before he's brought down. Nice job of running. Good blocking by Darrell Harris.
First and 10, Air Force 21-yard line. Here comes pressure. Tony Johnson, did he hold on? Goodness, that was a good hit by Mathis, but Tony Johnson did an excellent job. Tony from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Mario Mathis really tattoos him, but Tony Johnson, number 17, he'll be running out of the slot formation on the right. About his fourth catch of the night, I believe. He goes up in the air, pulls it down with his hands, does a nice job before he takes the pop from Mario Mathis. A good route, a good pass, and good defensive by Mario Mathis.
Gain of 9, second down 1, 12-yard line of the Falcons. Closing seconds of the first quarter, 7-0 Air Force leading. Harris, boy, that offensive line opened a hole for him, and it's going to be first and goal at the 4-yard line before, again, Mathis had to make the tackle.
Well, a good job by the left side of the offensive line. 62, Randall McDaniel and Fidel Underwood, the left guard and left tackle, or quick guard and quick tackle, opened a hole for Darrell Harris, who breaks one block. He's slowed down a little bit by Mario Mathis, otherwise touchdown. There he is, Darrell Harris.
Ford has completed 5 passes in a row. The Sun Devils now go to a 2 tight end offense. Knutson on the right side, Ryan McReynolds on the left side. First and goal at the Air Force 4. That's Chris Garrett in motion. Channing Williams gets about 2 yards to the 2-yard line.
He's a load. He's a big guy.
Deep, the nose guard, Dan Mullins, another down lineman. We're in on the defensive play, which is the final play of the first quarter. 7-0, Air Force leading, Arizona State threatening. Will return after these words from your local station. Williams at time is a tailback. Now, Williams set a team to fullback. They lined him up as a tailback. have used McDaniel. I think that's what's happened. They put Larson here.
McDaniel is the fullback.
And McDaniel as the fullback,
right.
Yeah. Play first and goal from the four. Randall McDaniel lined up as the fullback, number 62. He's there now. Williams, number 44, instead of being the fullback, is now the tailback. Second and goal, 2-yard line. Garrett in motion. Williams. Oh. Tremendous surge for the offensive line, and the Sun Devils are within a point of tying this game up, and I have a hunch, Jack Snow, that Randall McDaniel had something to do with that hole that was opened up.
Well, a hunch is right. I remember McDaniel at 274 pounds. He's a lead blocker. There he comes right at you. Great shot. 62 just buries the linebacker, 45, Randall Gladney. There's a hole big enough to drive a truck through. Ray, you and I could run through that hole together. Touchdown for Channing Williams.
You're really getting carried away with things. 11 plays, 71 yards. Williams the TD. Malstead will be the holder. Eddie Grant will be the snapper. And Alan Zendejas, who has been perfect in extra point conversions, 27 for 27, will try to make it 28 in a row and tie this game. And he does. So we're tied at 7 in the opening seconds of the second quarter. The Air Force at Arizona State. We'll be back in Anaheim after these words. So with the score tied at 7, Zendejas about ready to kick off, but we want you to see that scoring play.
With Channing Williams going in, he's the tailback in this formation. We're going to get a good shot over here from ground level now. The fullback in this particular situation will be Randall McDaniel. We'll see it after a bit.
Zendejas kicks. This will be Roberson, the Air Force 9. Good run back to about the 30-yard line.
We get a good shot from the ground level. Now, the first guy you're going to see going through the line of scrimmage there is, there's the lead blocker, McDaniel, at 274 pounds. He ties up the linebacker inside, creates a hole, big 44. Channing Williams comes in back, touchdown.
11-play drive that consumed 5 minutes and 21 seconds. And so now, it's the Falcons with the ball at their own 30-yard line. Lettinich, the quarterback. Give to the fullback, and he is met by Sauté Sapolu, who is the nose guard right now. He'll be doing some alternating at that position with Mark Duckins. That time was Sapolu. Rock Grote, what do you say, my friend?
Ray, as we've mentioned just a second ago, a big factor in that ASU drive, the ASU offensive line sitting down behind me, and one man in particular that wasn't on the line of scrimmage, number 62, quick guard Randall McDaniel playing fullback. They call that the foot team. They put him in when they need a foot or more, and they got it for the touchdown. Back to you.
A second and 10 play. Pass thrown, but tremendous pressure that time by Pat Taylor for one, number 51, and Trace Armstrong for another.
Outstanding job by ASU of putting the rush on the quarterback, Steve Lettinich. Coming from the outside is 51, Pat Taylor. Lettinich back to pass. He takes a shot right in the back, and that forces that ball to be incomplete. It's lucky that it was not intercepted. A heck of a job by Pat Taylor. There's Steve Lettinich, who took the shot. I don't think he'll be smiling now in the huddle, not after that last one he took.
So it's third and 10 Air Force from the Falcon 30. Now they split out two receivers this time. They seldom do that. Then they have a man in motion. Haven't seen that. Man in motion is Roberson. There goes Greg Johnson. Well, a gain only about 5 yards, and being a third down play, Rodney Dillard stayed home.
Key word. Rodney Dillard, number 21, the devil back, stayed home even though everything was going away from him. Takes a tackle and forced him into fourth down.
Blasey to punt. Nathan LeDuc to receive the punt. Oh, no height to that at all. LeDuc at the 35 of the Sun Devils. Gets a run back of about 11 yards, 29 yards. That's all there was on that punt. An 11-yard return, so ASU has excellent field position. We'll return after these words from your local station. Have a first and 10 at their own 45-yard line. Just the one running back in position is Channing Williams. Ford. Whoa! Somebody missed an assignment. A super defensive play by John Steed. Now, did he line up somewhere under the nose guard, Jack? How did he get so free?
He just comes through. He gets his keys. Number 81, he's on the nose, but he slides out to the right. The outside guy, Darrell Summerall, or Dan Mullins, I should say, comes down. He down blocks, which allows Steed to run a stunt, as they call it. He goes to the right. He comes wide open. Big play for the Air Force Academy.
So the young man from Little Rock causes an 8-yard loss. Daniel Ford and company faced with a 2nd and 18 at the Sun Devil 37. Early second quarter, 7-7 score. Now Channing Williams never turned around, number 44. Looked like he might have been the intended receiver, but Jack, I saw two potential receivers in the same area. That usually means that somebody ran a wrong pattern.
You saw two receivers in the same area. You also saw four Falcon defensive backs in that area. And I just think, to be honest with you, it was a misread by the quarterback. As you look at Greg Palka, one of the four guys was there. Lucky, very lucky for Daniel Ford, that ball was not intercepted.
So for the Sun Devils, it's 3rd and 18. Now Ford looked like he was going to line up as a shotgun quarterback. Well, he's going to now. Instant. Gary Kilmer made a great defensive play.
That's as fine a defensive play you'll see from anybody, anywhere. Gary Kilmer, the cornerback, after he was beaten by Aaron Cox.
There is Tyler Barth and Mike Shue. First punt, just 37. The average is almost 43. Oh, he gets great, great height on this one. Good hang time. Barth up to 13, back at the 12, in fact. But pretty good contain that time by the Sun Devils. And that was Floyd Fields, a freshman reserve defensive back. 7-7 our score here at the 4th Annual Freedom Bowl in Anaheim. And we'll be back right after these messages. His Air Force Falcons have the ball at their own 17-yard line, 1st and 10 in a 7-7 game. Letnich still has it to the outside, Roberson. Oh, there's a great play. There was a great defensive play by Eric Allen, that senior cornerback.
We'll get a good shot offensively. Nice execution, big splits by the lineman. Now watch, Letnich comes down. There's a guy supposed to take him. He pitches it out. Gets by, it looks like it's Malstead right there, 48, gets a hand on him, but Eric Allen in there also. Nice job. Good job of running by Anthony Roberson, but excellent defense by Arizona State.
Gain, 3 yards, 2nd down 7. 12:20 to play, first half. Air Force scored first, set up on a 40-yard run by the quarterback left. Levels came back and tied it, and that's where we are. Drew Metcalf, the freshman from Tempe, Arizona. That looked like they had the Sun Devils fooled there, Jack. They had a receiver out there.
They were so full. Great ball handling. 21. Albert Booker's going to come wide open at the top of the screen. There he is. See him by himself? All you got to do is get that ball up over the top because everybody is beaten. Drew Metcalf comes in there a little bit late, but he's in the right place at the right time.
Well, that would have been 6 points unless somebody had enough speed to catch a receiver because he was out there.
Well, again, we go back to the fact that Steve Letchness has only thrown 5 passes all year long.
First and 10, ASU, 20-yard line of the Falcons. Daniels back in his regular spot, by the way, of offensive guard. There's Darrell Harris. The Arizona State offensive line appears to be really making its presence felt against this much lighter defense of the Air Force.
Darrell Harris, number 12. See him? He's right there in the middle. He's the up back or the eye back. Ford's audibilizing right to his left. Now look at the blocking on the by the offensive line. There's 62 McDaniel. He gets the hole open. Harris pops it in there, picks up some big yardage, almost scores a touchdown. A nice job of running, but a super job of blocking.
12-yard gain, first and goal. 8-yard line of the Air Force. Pomona, California, not to be denied. He's down inside the two.
Darrell Harris again. You're going to see the right guard, Todd Cayley's number 65. Let's see what kind of a block he gets. There's 65 right there. Bang. He gets a good shot at number 60, but I'll tell you what, Darrell Harris just keeps finding the scene. He almost scores before he's finally brought down, among others, Mario Mathis.
Second and goal. The 2-yard line of the Air Force. Sun Devils trying to break a 7-7 tie. Motion. Harris again, followed Williams. Touchdown. The Sun Devils are on top, 13-7 on the 2-yard run by Darrell Harris. But that is a very, very big offensive line of the Sun Devils.
Big offensive line, a good job of blocking by the lead back, Channing Williams, but also Todd Kalis. He gets does a good job of blocking in there, also creates a huge hole. Remember, this offensive line of Arizona State at 280 pounds working against the defensive line of only 236. Advantage Arizona State, who's got a 218-pound fullback. Touchdown, Sun Devils.
Grant the snap. Also, the hold to Tejas to convert, which he does. He has yet to miss this season. 14-7. The Sun Devils have their first lead of the game. We'll return to Anaheim after these words from your local station. Roberson, Mason.
A minute and 3 seconds. 2-yard run by Harris.
Set up by a pass interception by Drew Metcalf. Then Dejas kicks off. This is Roberson at the 13th. Rock Rope, how do things look from down on your vantage point on the sidelines?
Well, my vantage point right now, Ray, is right behind the Air Force bench where the defensive line has just gotten a chewing out by the Air Force assistant coaches. The Air Force basically is just getting blown away on the line of scrimmage. Defensive line, obviously a lot smaller, as we mentioned. Arizona State far outweighs them, and they're back there trying to figure out what to do next time. Back to you.
Okay, Rock. The Falcons have it at their own 25-yard line. Now, remember, on that pass interception, Letnich, the quarterback, had a receiver wide open. But Metcalf, there's one Sean Patterson, limiting the game to just about a yard by Andy Smith, who replaced Quinton Roberts, a starting fullback. What in the world? Those are the colors of the Sun Devils. And I imagine Mama's saying, I hope that's washable.
Or I hope that's not my kid that's
yeah,
there.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. All right. Second down, 9. Falcons at their 26-yard line. Make to the full. Here comes Letnick to the 31-yard line, where the tackle's made by Robbie Boyd, the strong safety. This will set up a third down and a little, about 4 yards.
Jeff Malstead, now watch the quarterback, Steve Letnick. He does a good job. He's got his trail back out there, but here comes number 48, Malstead in there, makes the tackle, comes up and fills very nicely from his free safety position. There's a guy who's played with a lot of injury. Look at those eyes. Boy, he's in constant pain with a stress fracture, two bad knees, and he's just having a heck of a time.
You don't have enough time to get all the injuries. He's up.
Oh.
All right, third and four, Air Force 32. Fullback, just a couple. Andy Smith, Colorado Springs Jr.
John Patterson, probably a little bit upset by all the action that's been given to Hennings, but watch Patterson. He'll be number 97, comes flying across there. There he is, right. He just buries the blocker and knocks down the ball carrier. A heck of a job by Sean Patterson. All back 10, all American 13. Great job.
Blasey to punt. Chris Blasey. Nathan LeDuc to receive at the Sun Devil 25. At the 28. And nowhere to go. 4 yard return after a 38 yard punt. 14-7 is the score. The ASU Sun Devils in their final game under head coach John Cooper, who's headed for Columbus, Ohio and Ohio State. 14-7 ASU. We'll be back after these words.
Now Aaron Cox running a corner post route. He's wide open. Let's see, is there interference by the Air Force? There's a little touching right there. It looks to me like it's a little bit of incidental touching by Greg Palko. I don't know. That may be a cheap call.
We'll see.
Defensive pass interference. 15 yards first.
Well, the incidental contact was ruled enough for a 15-yard penalty against the Air Force.
Interesting, though, too, that as you look at Fisher DeBerry, he's kind of upset. Want to ask how? How could you call that? There was very little bumping going on. And the problem, though, that's one time when a bad pass, as you look at Cooper, a pass that hangs up a long time will get you 15 yards in a first down.
At the 47-yard line of the Sun Devils, Tony Johnson left, Aaron Cox to the right.
It's a big group right there as you look at and go back to their huddle again. Just huge across that front. 299, 274, 270, 276, and 284.
Larson, the senior linebacker from Canoga Park, California, made the tackle, limiting it to a 2 yard gain. Second down, 8. Ford. Incomplete. A little bit low for Aaron Cox. Defending was a cornerback, Gary Kilmer. It will be third down and 8.
Again, Aaron Cox running an out route against Gary Kilmer. It looked like he had him beat, which he did, but the ball just a tad late in getting there. Ford's got to release that ball just a little bit quicker to make that a completed pass. A good route run by Aaron Cox.
Ford, 7 of 13, 96 yards to this point from the shotgun. Although once in a while, he'll be back there, and then he'll go up under center, but not this time. Third and 8. Was almost picked off by Randall Gladney, who plays that outside linebacker spot, dropping back into pass defense. is for Mike Shue to punt and Barth to receive the punt. Tyler Barth back around the 10-yard line of the Air Force. 8:16 to play. First half. Into the sideline. Inside the play. He's going to get a great roll. Mike Shue down to the 8-yard line for the Air Force Academy. A 43-yard punt. So the Air Force Academy will be back at their 8-yard line. We'll be right back. To the 13-yard line. That's a gain of 5 on first down.
One thing the Air Force Academy does not want to do down here, if they're going to play action pass, they better get that ball into the hands of the receiver, and Letnis had better not be short, because if it's picked off again right down here, the Air Force Academy could be in real trouble trailing 14-7.
Sate Sapolu, number 94, who made the tackle on that last play, is leaving the game. Now, he'll be replaced at that nose guard spot, probably by Mark Douglas. We'll see if that is number 96 coming in.
Fisher sending in his play. He'll send it in with Tyler Barth. Both he and Steve Sten, as you mentioned, Ray, will both alternate the split end for the Air Force Academy, taking the plays in.
It's Bob Frankel, number 95, who came in at that nose guard spot. So it is second down, 5, Air Force at the Falcon 13. Midway, second quarter. Take to the full.
Play right here is the block that's going to be delivered by Greg Johnson, number 40. He blocks 29, Nathan LaDuke. LaDuke has responsibility for Johnson. A super block, and he's off to the races. Big play for Air Force. Takes him out of a deep hole. There he is, Albert Brooker. He reads very well. Read his blocking exceptionally well. Big gain for the Air Force Academy.
33-yard gain. First and 10, Air Force 46. 14-7, Arizona State. Officials agree with the Arizona State players. Second turnover by the Air Force. Who has the ball? Patterson was there.
I think Duckins came up with it.
Duckins was there.
Watch the smack now. Looks like that Letnich is going to turn up and pick up some big yardage. In comes the outside linebacker. Hits his helmet. Gets that helmet right on the football. A heck of a job. A nice job. It wasn't the linebacker. It was Jeff Malstead, the guy playing with all those injuries. Nice job, Jeff.
So, second turnover, as we mentioned. The first turnover was the interception by Drew Metcalf, the freshman linebacker, which was turned into a touchdown by the Sun Devils.
For the quarterback,
we'll see what happens here. Eddie Grant is now the center, replacing Sperling at that spot. Whoop, nowhere to go for Kurt Wendorf, mainly because waiting for him was Chad Hennings and Kevin Hughes.
Listening to Chad Hennings talk during the week, he was saying that all the publicity that goes along with the Outland Trophy, he's going to try and put that behind him, go out, have a good football game, and that's what he's done so far. A very, very big part, a big player for this Air Force Academy defensive unit.
Let's see what the offensive coaching staff of the Sun Devils sent in by way of wide receiver Chris Garrett, who is out to the right. After that loss of 4, second and 14, ASU 45. Wendorf in motion. Catch by Wendorf. That's close to a first down. 13-yard pickup. Wendorf is a junior from Granada Hills, or is that Granada Hills?
Granada Hills.
Granada Hills.
He's
okay.
Going to run a V in, a square, and he starts to the outside. Watch this catch. There's that right hand out there. Gets the tip of the ball, bounces it back inside. Super job. Nice job. He's going to be guarded by Mike Gant. Now, again, watch the catch. Watch his hand go out. Right hand way out there. Pulls it back in. Nice job. Excellent catch by number 20, Kirk Wendorf.
Now on third and two, guess who the fullback is now? Number 62, Randall McDaniel. The tailback is Williams. There goes Williams. He got the block. But Williams broke it to the outside and gets the first down at the 38 8-yard line of the Falcons as Gary Kilmer had to make the defensive play from his right corner spot.
Breaks to the outside, but maybe he can't see anything inside because he's got a 275-pounder leading the way. See, Channing Williams is not used to being the guy behind somebody.
Big difference in yardage as reflected by the first downs. Now, at left guard, when McDaniel comes to fullback, was Doug Larson, number 71. Wendorf is back at fullback. Left half back as they line up. His footbacks is Harris. First down play. Inside the 20-yard line, it is a catch by Fair. Ron Fair from Skyline, North Carolina, a junior wide receiver. Rick Palko made the stop. So the Sun Devils have very definitely taken over control of this game, Jack.
They have, and what they have seemed to what they seem to be doing right now, too, Ray, is they're saying to heck with it. Even though this is the last game of the year, we have a decided advantage in the running department, we're going to put that ball in the air and go crazy, and that's what they're doing so far.
5:17 to play first half, 14-7 Arizona State. From the 19-yard line, Wendorf was slowed down. Then the hit was made at just about the line of scrimmage. There'll be no gain on the play.
Another fine job by Derek Larson coming from his inline side linebacker spot, coming in to make the tackle for the Air Force Academy.
Rock, from your vantage point, Rock Road.
Yes, Ray, basically a very touchy situation right now for the Air Force. They have never come back from a deficit after the first half. They've won all nine of their wins by either being tied or being ahead at halftime. Back to you.
Second and 10, 19-yard line of the Air Force. For Aaron Cox. Well, there was attempt by the Air Force to put pressure on the quarterback, and that left Kilmer one-on-one with Cox, but off target was the pass by Ford. It's going to be third and 10 at the 19-yard line of the Air Force.
You look at Aaron Cox come back, and that's one thing that offensive coordinator Jim Coletto wanted. He wanted to try and get Aaron Cox isolated on whoever the cornerback may be. Daniel Ford, 9 of 17 for 127 yards. Ford had Aaron Cox, just could not get the ball to him.
And Ford has completed those nine passes to six different receivers. Here's a big third and 10. The only running back is Harris. The arm was hit. Good pressure that time. Now, Hennings was in the vicinity of the quarterback, and it was Hennings who hit his arm.
You look at Kirk Wendorf. When he turned around to look for the ball, it was just kind of half-heartedly. Cooper, he's going, what are you doing? What are you doing? Throw the football. Get the ball out there. Get it to the receivers. He's upset. Come on. Come on, he's saying to Daniel Ford.
So on fourth down, Alan Zendejas will attempt a 36-yard field. The snapper is Eddie Grant. The holder is Jeff Malstead. The Sun Devils, having trailed 7-0, tied it at 7, moved ahead 14-7. Now it is 17-7.
Well, you can see Air Force just continuing to dig a hole. It may be very, very difficult to get out of in the second half. But again, a good mixture of offensive play calling by Arizona State. Good running and good passing at times, although they had not connected at every opportunity via the pass. They have been able to run the ball very well.
The Sun Devils. It was a season in many ways of frustration, particularly as measured against last year, when for the first time in their history, ASU went to the Rose Bowl and defeated Michigan. But a lot of what are referred to by coaches as impact players were lost from that squad. And I think a lot of people in the Tempe, Arizona area, followers wherever of the Sun Devils, Jack, felt upon reflection that maybe expectations were a little too high for this year.
Yeah, I think so. In particular, as you and I were talking about earlier in the day, the devastated secondary of Arizona State. Thank goodness that they're playing a team tonight that is not a passing team.
Zendejas kicks. Roberson at the 12. He has great speed. There goes a flag as from behind. Jefferson, boy, he can fly. Was caught by, that Rick Zumwalt has good speed. My goodness.
Yes, he does. My goodness is right. He was flying, and he put a hit on him, too. A nice job by Zumwalt. We may have an illegal block below the waist by one of the Air Force Academy guys on the return team. Is Anthony Roberson, 5'8", 160 pounds. Not a big guy, but a very happy guy. Look at that smile. He's just happy to be here.
Blocking below the waist on the blue team, 15 yards from the spot. First and 10.
You know, I have a feeling, Jack, that that infraction, which is called so many times at every level of football, is a result of the fact that it's a fairly new rule, and from the time the kids first play football, many occasions you're taught to block below the waist.
Well, exactly. That plus one other factor, Ray. If I'm going to block, and I was an offensive player at 190 pounds, and I had to come up against Dick Butkus, am I going to hit him in the chest? No way. I'm going to hit him right at his shoe top, or try to anyway.
Tough penalty against the Falcons. Puts him back to their own 17-yard line. Very short gain. Geez, are you left hand back in there? Last man up, the young man who scored the Air Force touchdown, Greg Johnson, the sophomore from San Antonio. Gain 3 yards, second down 7. Once again, the messenger. Steve Senn replaces Tyler Barth at that wide receiver spot. Number 83 will come out to the left. Letnich, the quarterback, number 14. Take to the fullback, to the air. Oh, good pass to Senn. First down at the 38-yard line with 3:25 left to play in the half. A 17-yard gain. I think that's the first completion for the Falcons.
I don't discount that, but a heck of a job by Steve Senn, who started on the near side towards us over here, as you see him run off the field. Ran a simple crossing route just underneath all of the linebackers and defensive backs, and a good pass that time by Steve Letnich to get the ball to him and let him run. Shows good quickness.
First down at the Air Force 38. Take to the full, to the air. Oh, wide open. Greg Johnson. Oh, my goodness sakes. 31-yard gain.
That's the same play design, Ray, that they tried earlier in the ball game. It was picked off. An excellent job of play action by Steve Letnich. Greg Johnson, who had faked or was used as a blocker, breaks wide open. 39 comes in there, Eric Crawford, and saves a touchdown. Little play action fake. See, there he is, number 40 at the top. He runs right by the linebacker, Mark Tingstad, and that's Tingstad's responsibility is to put the hammer on Greg Johnson. Nice play call.
First and 10, Sun Devil 31. Give to the fullback this time, Andy Smith. Now, that give to the fullback has not really been successful for the Falcons so far.
It has not been successful, but you do it to keep that defense honest. Every time you hand that ball off to that fullback, those inside backers, Drew Metcalf and Mark Tingstad, have got to come in there to honor that. The first time they get lazy and don't come down there to force that fullback is when you let him sneak through.
Stacy Harvey, who was involved in a moped accident, number 57, is in at that one linebacker spot. Take to the full. Here he goes to the air. Receivers were covered, and there's Sean Patterson. So Sean Patterson defensively for the Sun Devils, Chad Hennings defensively for the Air Force Academy. In my opinion, Jack, have certainly lived up to everything we heard they could do.
Absolutely. Two of the finest. Little play action, a short roll to his left side. Here comes 97, Sean Patterson. He gets his hands up in the air. Letnich pulls the ball down. He should have gone ahead and tried to throw it, because once he does not throw that ball, there he is, big Sean Patterson, all packed in. Heck, he benches 450 pounds.
2 minutes left to play, first half, 17-7, Arizona State. Here's a big third and 14 for the Air Force. Wow.
Whoa.
Flag down. Well, that was Mark Tingstad, who had dropped back in pass coverage, number 59.
His defending. Man. That's right. That's his man, number 40, Greg Johnson. He can't find the ball. He being Tingstad, he gets a hand up there. They're going to call face guarding, I'll bet you. I could be wrong, and I have been more times than I'm right, but they may call face guarding.
I'd have to believe it's a defensive penalty, because John Cooper is arguing, it appears from here he's arguing.
Defensive pass interference, 15 yards, first.
So the Air Force Academy down by 20-yard line of ASU. Now out wide to the right is Tyler Barth. Rick Allen will defend against him. Fake to the full. Letnich still has it. Close to a first down around the 10. Now that was almost as successful for 10 yards as his 40-yard run, which set up the Air Force touchdown.
Exactly, and that's a good job by the quarterback recognizing on the run that it is my shot and I've got to keep the ball. Do not pitch it out. We'll get a good look at it right here. You fake inside the fullback, Andy Smith. He's got his tailback, Greg Johnson. Takes time. He gets a good block from out there from Frank Martini. Tries to use him, cut back inside before he's finally brought down by Trace Armstrong.
Second and less than one for a first down. Just over a minute to play in the half. Smith has a first down and goal around the 8-yard line. Now, there's a change defensively. David Newmore, a junior, has replaced Sean Patterson. Now, I've seen no evidence that Patterson was injured, and I mention this because it would seem unusual if Patterson were out at this very important stage of the first half.
Maybe he's got a little bit of a ding, so he may be on the sideline trying to either get retaped, or maybe he's got a little bit of a bump or bruise he has got to have looked at. But I'm sure that he'll be back in there if he's at all healthy at all.
Clock running with about 50 seconds left to play in the half. First and goal, some little late for the Air Force. Second and goal. Stacy Harvey, number 57. Robbie Boyd, number 26, made the stop.
If you're the linebacker, this is what it looks like coming right at you. There's 48 Malstead. He comes in there to mop up after a good job of sliding down the line of scrimmage by Stacy Harvey, number 57, and saves a touchdown for Arizona State.
A timeout has been called here by the Air Force. The Panthers, Texas, the Longhorns. Tomorrow night, the Bluebonnet Bowl in Houston, Texas. 8 o'clock Eastern time. We suggest for a local listing to find out about the Pitt Panthers. Had a great year. Beat Penn State. Beat Notre Dame.
Why do you smile when you say they beat Notre Dame, Ray?
Well, no, look, I want to hastily add something there. No, look.
They're a good, you're right, they are a good.
I got to defend myself. Lou Holtz is a good friend, okay? I broadcast Pitt games many years ago. I just hope that it's a great football game.
There will be an excellent game. Two good teams, and Pittsburgh, there's no question they have an outstanding football team.
All right. Second and goal, Air Force, Sun Devil 3. 37 seconds left to play in the half. 17-7, Sun Devils leading. Fake to the full. There's a touchdown by the attack back, Booker. Albert Booker. And friends, we have ourselves a football game. 17-13 now. Letnich is a very cool young man for having played as little as he's played this year in such an important spot as the quarterback in a wishbone attack.
Exactly, because there are so many things that quarterback has got to think of, and a nice job of running by Albert Booker, who just does get inside the corner of the pylon. A super job again by the youngsters from the Air Force Academy. Great execution, a nice long drive.
So now, Steve Yarbrough will try to make it 17-14. Executed. The snap by Bullard, the hold by Olson, the kick by Yarbrough. 30 seconds left in the half.
We're going to get another shot of it. Now watch Lettner right here. Look at that. Nice job pulling the ball away. Then he pitches that ball out. Albert Booker. Does he get inside? Yes, he does. He takes a hit from Jeff Malstead, but a nice job of getting in. Touchdown, Air Force.
Now there was a flag on the extra point.
On the defense, after the extra point, 15 yards on the kickoff.
So the kickoff, instead of being from the Air Force 35, will be from the 50. Personal foul against the Sun Devils. Actually, the game has been fairly free of penalties.
It has been. It's been a good, clean ball game so far. The teams are definitely out there smacking each other around, but it's been a very, very clean ball game. A big, big play, big series for Arizona, or excuse me, for Air Force to drawing within three. If they hadn't scored down there, been tough.
Peach Bowl this Saturday, Tennessee Volunteers, coached by Johnny Majors, the Indiana Hoosiers, coached by Bill Mallory. 1 o'clock Eastern Time. Tennessee, Indiana, on many of these same MSLU television network stations. Hope you join us. Cinderella year for those Hoosiers of Indiana. Now, the Sun Devils have Winsley and Cahoon back, but I would be a little surprised if Yarbrough here doesn't kick it.
Yeah, squib it maybe, a little squib kick maybe.
Yeah, Albert Booker at the tail end of that 83-yard drive, and much of that yardage, surprise, through the air.
Yeah, surprisingly, a big key pass in that drive to keep the drive going, and some good runs by Lechner. Excellent job, or excuse me, Letnich. I don't know why I want to call him Lechner, but it's Letnich.
Yarbrough to kick. Maybe he'll just bounce this along. Let's see. Oh, an attempt at on. Eric Allen made absolutely certain that the Sun Devils would have possession. Now, they have it at their own 38. That took 1 second off the clock. What do you think? Conservatively now?
Well, I don't know. They got 29 seconds to go. You can get off conservatively, I'd say, four plays if you want to have one down the middle. They've got a couple of timeouts left. There's plenty of time to either score a touchdown or get themselves in position for a Zendejas field goal attempt.
Three timeouts, the full quota remaining to the Sun Devils. The Air Force has used just one. Now, Tony Johnson, who's had a good night, is off to the left. Aaron Cox, the number one receiver, is off to the right. New tailback, David Winsley from Birmingham. This is for Aaron Cox. He's out there. Touchdown. 61 yards. The speed of Aaron Cox. There was good faking there by Daniel Ford, enabled him to have the time to get the ball for Cox to run under.
You'll see Daniel Ford play action fake to his left side. Now watch him drop back. He's looking to his right side. He's got man-to-man coverage. Aaron Cox, he runs a go route. A super job. He gets by Gary Kilmer. Kilmer just not quick enough to stay with him. Touchdown. Easy touchdown for Arizona State.
So just like that, the score goes from 17-14 to 23-14. Aaron Cox playing in his home area. Malstead, the holder, on a snap from Grant. Zendejas, who has yet to miss an extra point, maintains his perfect record. So an unusual turn of events. A 15-yard penalty on the extra point, which is measured off on the following kickoff.
Here it is again. Again, a play action pass to your fullback, Channing Williams. You come back, you roll to the other side, you lay that ball out there. A nice job of concentration by Eric Cox. Makes the catch, in for his fifth touchdown of the year.
Aaron Cox came into the game having caught 38 passes for 760 yards. But I know that having talked to a great number of pro scouts, they said, hey, this is one of the top receivers in college football.
There's no question of that. He does a lot of things very, very well. He will go across the middle to catch a football. He'll catch it in the crowd. He runs good out routes. He's got good concentration on the long bomb.
So in the closing seconds here, the first half, we've had 14 points scored, 7 by the Air Force and 7 by the Sun Devils in the final minute. Roberson and Faison, we don't know yet about the speed of Faison based on tonight's performance. We know that Roberson can fly.
He's got good speed, good quickness, and again, it'll be interesting to see what happens. I think Air Force, that last onside kick came back to backfire against him.
Zendejas kicks. Sun Devils 5 and no time off the clock, and we have only 21 seconds left to play in the first half.
I think if I were the Arizona State team, I would go ahead and kick that ball off as far as you can, because I don't think Air Force has the explosiveness, the ability to strike deep very quickly. They're a ball control, grind them out type team, and they're just not capable of putting one quick play on the board.
So we do it all over again, but this time from the 40. Faison, 27. Roberson, 20. Back from the 30-yard line now, while Zendejas booted away. What did Rock Roach say that when the Air Force trailed at the half, they have not been able to come back and win.
Exactly. They have not won a ball game this year that they have trailed in at halftime.
Oh, the return man just switched sides. Roberson is now not going to be Roberson. Well, let's see who number 29 is.
Rodney Lewis.
Rodney Lewis, I think. Although he's listed as wearing number 28, I think it's Rodney Lewis.
I think so.
Well, will the Air Force Academy, this ground-oriented wishbone attack team, go to the air? Lettich did it successfully on their second touchdown drive.
Excellent field position, Ray, with the ball on the 39-yard line. Not that far to go for at least an attempt at a field goal. Let's see what the Air Force does here.
Well, they have two wide receivers. They don't do that very often. They have Sen and Barth. There goes Johnson in motion. He tried to surprise the Sun Devils by running up the middle. But Sean Patterson was waiting, and friends. And that will be the final play of the first half, which has seen 38 points scored here in the fourth annual Freedom Bowl. Arizona State, 24. Air Force Academy, 14. We'll return after these words from your local station.
Score is 24-14 at halftime, and joining me right now is the Freedom Bowl Executive Director, Tom Starr. Tom, absolutely an exciting bowl game thus far. I know you're very pleased about that.
Well, we are, Rock. Obviously, we knew the two teams coming in, they had averaged about four touchdowns a game, and they haven't disappointed us. It's a fun game.
One thing I noticed down on the field on the sidelines, it was quite wet. A lot of rain yesterday, but it seems like the field is in pretty good condition.
Well, it really is at this point. You know, you're right. We did have some rain yesterday, and we had our fingers crossed today, and it paid off. And we have a good night out here.
Let's talk about the Freedom Bowl. Started back in 84, obviously one of the fastest growing bowls in the country.
Well, we are. We think that because of the things we have to offer, of course, a great stadium, wonderful weather, the entertainment that we have out here with obviously the theme parks and the beaches and so forth, and it's a great media market and a great recruiting area. So I think all those things combined have made us that way. We've been proud of all the teams we've had. Our corporate support continues to grow every year, and our popularity in the area continues to grow. So we are very pleased with the growth of it.
One thing that surprisingly became a part of the Freedom Bowl this year was the word that ASU head coach John Cooper is heading to Ohio State. Did that affect the bowl, the publicity for the bowl?
Well, I think it did. Obviously, we were in kind of the national limelight because Coach Cooper is in the game, and of course, that's been heavily rumored. It doesn't affect us to a great extent. I'm sure it does the team more so than us. What it does do, we've had a great media response from the state of Ohio today. We probably had 20 calls from Ohio, and they're sending out reporters and television people and so forth. So that's really the only way it affects us.
Tom, quickly, future plans for the Freedom Bowl?
Well, we plan to continue our growth. We need to get our corporate sponsorships even greater. We need to appeal more to the casual fan. Our sales to the schools have been great. Our sales to the corporations have been good. And now we need to do that, and I think we'll just continue to grow.
Tom, thanks a lot. Tom Starr, Executive Director of the Freedom Bowl. We'll be back with more from the 1987 Freedom Bowl after these words from your local station. We are at halftime here in the Freedom Bowl. Arizona State leading the Air Force Academy 24-14. Joining me right now is the new president of the Freedom Bowl, Bill Snyder. Bill, you've been with this bowl since before it began in 1982. You saw the first game played in 84. You've been with it from the start. Has it grown rapidly in your mind?
It has, but it seems like I've been with it longer than that. Yes, I was part of the team that put together the audiovisual presentation to the NCAA, and it has grown rapidly. We've gone from just six meager sponsors in 1984 to this year 144. And we've had a steady growth. We've expanded into a basketball tournament. We've added a Queens Festival, a high school band festival, and we're looking to add some more next year.
I know that Anaheim and surrounding communities are very important to you in this bowl.
They surely are, which is why we've tried to make it more than just Anaheim and get it into Orange County. Actually, our basketball tournament is taken down into the South County just to get them involved, too.
Yeah. All right, Bill, I know you're happy with a very exciting first half, too.
We are, especially the second quarter.
All right. Thank you, Bill Snyder, the president of the Freedom Bowl, and we'll be back with these messages right after this timeout.
As we near the end of our halftime intermission here at the fourth annual Freedom Bowl in Anaheim, perhaps we better re-identify ourselves. I'm Ray Scott, my colleague, our analyst tonight, Jack Snow. Those, Jack, that felt that a lot of points would be on the board here this evening must have known something. 38 points in the first half, and I think you have the highlights all set here.
38 points by both teams, a lot more points we thought. Air Force opened up the scoring, a 13-yard run by Greg Johnson. A little play action faking here by the quarterback, and they'll watch him start coming down the line of scrimmage. Fakes inside, flicks it out to Greg Johnson, number 40, who takes it in. 13-yard run, Air Force goes out on front, 7-0 in the first quarter. Second quarter, ASU comes back on a 2-yard run by Channing Williams right up the gut behind some good blocking by that offensive line. They tie the score 7-7. Arizona State's going to come back now with Darrell Harris. Again, a 2-yard run, takes the pitch from Ford off the left side of the line into the end zone. Touchdown ASU. They go up 14-7. Air Force will come back. Albert Booker on a 3-yard run off the wishbone. Fakes inside, flicks that ball outside. There's Booker, 3-yard run, capping an 83-yard drive in the second quarter. ASU takes an onside kick that they recover. First play after the onside kick, Daniel Ford goes up top, 61 yards to Aaron Cox. A touchdown for ASU puts them ahead by 10, 24-14 at the half. A nice job, a nice run by Aaron Cox after the catch.
Now, meanwhile, the third member of our broadcast team, Rock Road, pointed out a little while ago that the Air Force has not been able this past season to win a game when they were behind at the halftime. This tells you something about the total yardage in the game. As we expected, the Air Force Academy surpassing the Sun Devils on the ground, and in the air, it was the Sun Devils.
Sun Devils very, very strong. The two turnovers by the Air Force Academy really definitely did not help their cause.
And again, the Air Force Academy has not been able to win, been trailing at the half. Now, they were able to surprise the Sun Devils on several occasions by throwing successfully. But whether that'll happen in the second half remains to be seen.
Exactly. It's going to be a very interesting second half. The Air Force Academy may try and come out and put the ball in the air a little bit more than they're normally accustomed to. On the other hand, I would look to see for ASU to keep that ball on the ground and really grind it out.
So we're just about ready for the second half kickoff. Sun Devils will be set to take the second half kickoff with Dick Cahoon, number 31, David Winsley, number 37, back for the kickoff from Yarbrough. 24-14 Sun Devils. Oh my, short kick. This is Cahoon with great speed. Saving tackle made by the kicker. That's right, made by the kicker.
Yarbrough doesn't get him, nobody does. You're absolutely correct. A nice job by Yarbrough. Those kickers don't like to be put in that type of position very often, but a good job that time by Yarbrough.
So the Daniel Ford-led Sun Devil offense has a great launching spot here. They're on 46-yard line, first and 10, as we're ready for the first play from scrimmage of the second half. Tony Johnson, who's had a good first half, is out to the right, and Aaron Cox is off the left. Short of the line of scrimmage, 44-yard line. Chad Hennings ran him out of bounds, but John Steed actually forced him to hold onto the ball, the way I looked at it, Jack.
Exactly. Steed was the man who pressured him out of bounds, but he was looking downfield. He wanted to go to his tight end, Gary Knutson. Knutson was covered, and that's after he looked off of Aaron Cox, who was going deep. Both guys covered very well by the secondary of the Air Force Academy.
Garrett wide right, Cox wide left. Second down, 12, Sun Devil 44.
Successful for Arizona State all night long. The out pattern. Here's Daniel Ford. Little play action faking there to Harris to hold the linebackers. In the meantime, Cox is running a square out against Gary Kilmer. Kilmer playing very soft in the secondary. Makes the catch, goes out of bounds. You're right, a late hit. A good call by the official. Get another look at this now. Cox, remember, he's going out of bounds after the catch. He's just going to stroll out of bounds because his momentum is going to carry him. They'll watch what happens with Gary Kilmer. A close call, very close to the sidelines, but definitely a late hit.
costly penalty because the Sun Devils have moved on the penalty plus the 19-yard pass to the 22-yard line of the Air Force. First and 10. Whoop. Ball smooth. Tight end, Gary Knutson. And this apparently will now cost the Sun Devils 5. We had a comparatively free from penalty first half here at Anaheim.
10 ball. Illegal procedure on the offense. Still first down.
So the ball comes back to the 27-yard line. First and 15. And the messenger is Tony Johnson.
See if Daniel Ford goes back to the air now. Johnson and Cox both had great nights so far for Arizona State. And they do have, especially Johnson, has a one-on-one out there at the far top of the screen.
Channing Williams fumble, and the Air Force has it. First turnover by the Sun Devils. So the Air Force Academy comes up with the loose football.
Kevin Hughes, the outside backer for the Air Force Academy, comes up, stops a good drive. Ford is going to drop back here, or not drop back, but just a quick hitter. A super job by penetration by the Air Force. And again, that's 87. Chad Hennings forcing that fumble. Great angle right here. Watch him get that helmet right on that football. Channing takes the ball at the same time. Hennings gets his hat right on that football. It pops loose. Big recovery by Kevin Hughes.
Sixth fumble forced by Hennings this season. Back, Quinton Roberts, who started the game, sustained a slight injury. He's back there, number 33. Only about 2 yards from Roberts before he ran into Pat Taylor for one, Trace Armstrong for another, Sean Patterson for a third. Gain, 2 yards, second down, 8. In with a message is sophomore wide receiver from Albuquerque, Steve Senn, number 83. He'll come out to the right. Eric Allen and Robbie Boyd. He's drawing double coverage. Very close to first down yardage at the 37-yard line. Steve Letnich.
Letnich doing a great job on a quarterback sneak. A drop step with his right foot right up the gut. The interior defensive wall for Arizona State looking for some movement either left or right and not straight ahead. Excellent call by the offensive coordinator, Bob Noblet. Big first down by Steve Letnich.
Not quite the first down. Third and about 2 feet.
Almost a nice quite first down.
Very good. The player was down. Trace Armstrong will not be able to fulfill the dream of every defensive lineman. Letnich was dropped.
Dropped, yes, you bet. Nice job by Stacy Harvey. Now watch Letnich right here. Fakes inside to the fullback, pulls the ball out. He's looking for his trailback, but he can't do a good job. He's brought down by Pat Taylor, 51, the outside backer, who gets in on the quarterback in a hurry, takes him down.
Chris Blasey to punt, Nathan LeDuc to accept the punt. Good punt. LeDuc at his own 28. 35, 40. Good return by the freshman from Phoenix. 40-yard punt, 17-yard return, Sun Devil possession. They lead the Air Force Academy by 24-14 in the opening moments of the second half. And we'll be back to Anaheim. Devils first and 10, their own 44. We played 2 minutes of the second half. ASU leading by 10, 24-14. Ford might be checking off. Harris. Good speed. Continue there. Very effective moving with the football. First down, 41-yard line of the Air Force after a 14-yard gain. Daniel Ford has completed 11 of 20 passes, 206 yards, one touchdown, that to his favorite receiver, Aaron Cox. Mike Gant made a saving tackle that time for the Air Force. Cox and Garrett go off to the right. Darrell Harris, who had a good 855-yard season performance coming into the game. Harris again. 3 yards before the right cornerback, Gary Kilmer, led the defensive surge.
Good back. Darrell Harris, number 12, a very, very good back. First team all Pac-10 this year, 185-pound senior, has had a very good career. Good runner, also a good receiver coming out of the backfield for ASU this year.
Picked up about three, second down seven. Tony Johnson brought in the message and lines up wide right. Appears to have single coverage. Person with Palco, the left cornerback. Second down seven. Pressure. Flag down. Cox is wide open. But remember, there is a flag. 38-yard pass completion. There is a flag down behind the line. Appears it's going to be called back. Yep, there it is.
Normally, as you alluded to earlier in the first half, when you see the flag in that area of the football field, it's going to be a holding call. It takes a big, big play away. You're going to get a chance to see some scrambling. Let's see if we can see the holding call. 62, Randall McDaniels there on the left side. He comes back inside. There it is right there. Sticks out his right arm and tries to make it. Looks like Fidel Underwood gets called for the hold. Takes a big touchdown away. Get another shot right here. Look for 64, Fidel Underwood. He'll be the left tackle. Gets a hand out there. We can't see it, but just really a shame because it really takes away a big, big play and 6 points for sure for Arizona State.
So instead of adding to that 10-point lead, the Sun Devils will draw a 10-yard penalty. Second down, 20.
That'll drive coaches crazy. You know, they don't like to have those holding penalties on a successful play, but when you have a play for a touchdown, that I bet you Cooper just blew right out of his shoes on that last play.
I'll correct that slightly. It's second down 18. It was spotted at the 49-yard line of the Air Force. Fake to Harris. Was that a forward pass or was it a fumble? Forward pass, says the referee. Referee Dean Kramer ruled that his arm was going forward, but the pressure from Chad Hennings.
Hennings been in there all day long, number 87. They'll line him up at the nose guard. They'll line him up as a defensive end. Now watch for it. Look for 87. Here comes 81, comes in there. He jumps up in the air. He gets a hand on him. So in combination, John Steed and Chad Hennings are responsible for making a good defensive play for the Air Force Academy.
Third down, 18, 49 of the Air Force. Ford. 5 yards deep. Very good protection. Fumble. Hughes has it for the Air Force. 41-yard line of ASU. Kevin Hughes recovered. Dan Mullins forced it. And the Air Force Academy has a second ASU turnover.
This drives coaches crazy. He avoids one rusher. There's no question of that. Does a nice job of getting by the first one. But then he takes so long, that should never happen. He's got to get rid of that football. There's no question of that. You can see it right here. Mullins goes up, forces him to pull the ball back down. But to be honest with you, Daniel Ford has got to get rid of that ball. He can't sit there and hold it. Kevin Hughes, the big man, 231-pound outside linebacker, comes in and falls on it for the Air Force Academy.
Can the Falcons capitalize? Tyler Barth is at wide left. Fake to the full. Picked off, just like that. Should be Eric Crawford. Yep, number 39, Eric Crawford. He plays the right corner.
That'll take you out of a ball game in a hurry. You got a big chance. You just recovered a fumble by your opponent. You turn right around and cough the ball back up. They just hate that. Let's take a good look. Letnitz is dropping back to pass. He's looking for Tyler Barth, who is open, but then again, a late delivery. Barth not real tall at 5'9". He goes up at a super job by 39, Eric Crawford, to come in. Another look at it. Let that ball go right now. Throw it now. He's just a little bit late. Now watch how high Barth has to go up. He can't go up quite high enough. A good juggling act. Looked like a volleyball player there, Eric Crawford. Nice job, Eric.
Third Air Force turnover. First and 10, ASU at their own 32. First down. Gary Knutson, the tight end, to the 38. Rock Broke. Did those turnovers look any different down there?
You bet.
great. It's a roller coaster of emotion down here on the ASU bench. I'd imagine the same way on the Air Force bench. Turnovers on one side, they get depressed. All of a sudden, they get it back. They're back up again. It's definitely on a roller coaster. We'll see where that roller coaster ends at the end of the ball game. Back to you.
Gain of six on the pass to Knutson, the tight end. Second down, four. Sun Devil 38. 11:04 to play, third quarter. ASU leads by 10. 24-14.
Player running right at you. Now watch him put a couple of moves on, gets by a couple of tacklers. There's Mario Mathis, who he fakes. Now look, there's 41, Greg Palko, who should make the tackle. Harris keeps those knees turning, breaks away from two tacklers. 11 rushes, 84 yards, and a touchdown before he's finally run out of bounds by one of the Falcons.
Two new wide receivers are in. Tony Johnson, Ron Fair, new tailback, David Winslow. 5'5", 190, the tailback, number 37. Harris is getting his rebound.
Get up!
It was Williams, but not very far.
Williams.
Well, let's see. Do we have enough time to give all the people in there? We saw 87. There's Sumrall for another. Derek Larson for another. No gain. Second down 10, Air Force 30. And the leading tackler of the Falcons was also involved in an assist, Rip Bergwald. Sperling and Grant have been alternating at center for ASU. It's Sperling now.
Again, he's moving all over the field. We have seen him. I've lost him a couple of times. You keep looking at him. It's a left defensive end. Sometimes he's a nose tackle. He'll be coming from the left side of your screen. Again, four dropping back to pass, wanting to go to the slot side. There's 87, big Chad Hennings, coming into this game with 46 career sacks, 24 this year. Gets himself another one.
His fourth one tonight. And a loss of eight. Third down, 18. The 15-yard line, a 25-yard gain. Chris Garrett, the St. Paul, Minnesota junior.
Chris Garrett reacting to the audible for a dog blitz, a safety blitz, a little quick post move. He beats Greg Palko. I'll tell you, 18, Mario Mathis almost came in to pick that off. Great concentration by Chris Garrett.
Garrett stays in and lines up wide right. Fair, Ron Fair to the left. First and 10. Make a saving tackle at the 5-yard line, gain of eight. Second down, two.
Fine performance by the right guard, Todd Kalish. And you talked to me about him a lot today, Ray. He did a good job on that last play of pulling and leading the sweep, getting a good block for Darrell Harris.
Double tight end now set up. Knutson on the one tight end, and McReynolds the other. Second and two. Ford still has the ball. Just playing too low to be caught.
Exactly. Channing Williams, a good receiver, has caught 10 passes on the season, has a decent pair of hands. He had his man, Mike Gant. He had Gant beat, but again, the ball just was a little low, was not there.
Third down and two at the Air Force 5. Aaron Cox checks back in with the word from the offensive coaches. Harris. had innings. How many?
I don't know.
Kept track of how many tackles he's made.
We know
he's had four sacks.
Right, I know what you're going to say, and it came out of my mouth before it came out of yours. Hennings has been all over that field for the Air Force.
It appears that we will have an Allens and Dejas attempt at a 21-yard field goal out of a Jeff Malstead hold and Eddie Grant snap. 21-yard. So Zendejas, 2 of 3 tonight. The scoreboard changes for the first time in the second half to 27-14 in favor of ASU, and we'll return after these words from your local station. Safe to say they probably outnumber fans here who have followed the Sun Devils by at least 2-1. Well, let's see what the Air Force can do from their own 18 first and 10. Less than 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. The fullback had the ball, but Andy Smith didn't. Steve Letnich kept it.
Letnich wished the fullback had the ball on that one. He took a pop in the noggin there, but he held on. He's shaking. Shake the cobwebs out, young man. You'll be okay. He's a competitor, though, Ray. Listening to him talk, he said his biggest asset was he had a strong head, and he exhibited that on that last play.
Picked up a couple. 2nd and 8, 20-yard line of the Air Force. Roberts is in now at fullback instead of Smith. Fake to Roberts. Whoop! Ball batted down. Now Pat Taylor was right there for one.
I think Taylor was in the area.
And Dwayne King was right there. That linebacker in place of... there's another freshman in there for the Sun Devils. He's from Toms River, New Jersey. Dwayne King.
Richard DeBerry looking a little upset right now. He can see things starting to get away from him. He's got to get back in control. He's got to get that ball moving up and down the field and get something on the board. Otherwise, for him, the game is out because his offense can't play catch-up that well.
Two wide receivers and a slot back on 3rd down 8. Throw back. The thought was good, but the Sun Devils were waiting that time.
Good block, too, by the offensive center, Blake Geddes, all whack second team, 6'2", 260 pounds, as you look at Fisher.
And the very busy young man tonight has been Chris Blasey. And Nathan LeDuc has already had several pretty good punt returns. He's a freshman from Phoenix. Less than a minute to play in the third quarter. Good bounce for the Sun Devils, and they're going to have it at their own 47-yard line. Just a 30-yard punt. Down by Eric Faison, who's one of the kickoff return men for the Air Force Falcons. Daniel Ford. He's waiting a ruling, you know, Jack, as to whether he will have another year of eligibility. A little bit of a technicality involved on when he left the University of Minnesota and transferred. He claims that there's no question he's going to get that extra year, but there's been no decision yet. Tailback spot has been very productive for the Sun Devils tonight. The last I looked, Darrell Harris had around 84, 85 yards. Winsley now has brought that total from the tailback position up to around 100, I would say. He's pretty close to it.
So Winsley will bring to the party quickness and speed. There's no question of that. The only thing that he does not have that Darrell Harris has is the experience. Harris, a very experienced runner, but David Winsley, as we said earlier, a lot can be expected of him.
The end of the third quarter, 27-14, ASU over the Air Force. Back here after these messages.
Welcome back. As we mentioned a while ago, it is getting colder and colder with every passing moment here in Anaheim, California, at the Freedom Bowl. One guy who's really paying his dues right now is Ken Hutton. He's from the Anaheim Stadium staff, and he's got to fill up all these ice waters for the team. Ray and Jack, I think they might want to change to hot chocolate next time for a night like tonight. What do you think?
Okay. Meanwhile, the little man from Flagstaff, Arizona, little but powerful and quick. David Winsley takes that screen pass 13 yards. Now, that was very well done.
Excellent execution on the part of the Sun Devils. A nice job by Ford of dropping back, allowing Winsley to get in behind that big offensive line. Look at those third quarter stats, Ray. Look at the total yard for Arizona State, 349 yards.
Even though time of possession favors by 10 seconds, the Air Force. First down, Sun Devils, 35-yard line of the Falcons. Williams, good move. There's a blocker. Aaron Cox was screening pretty well for him, and all the way to the 15-yard line on a 19-yard run by Channing Williams before Palko was able to make the tackle.
Remember now, this guy's a fullback. You expect him to see him go tackle to tackle, but look at the move. One little inside move, he bounces to the outside, gets by two guys. Another move before he's finally brought down by Craig Palko. A nice job of running by Channing Williams. 5.9 yards per carry so far this year. An outstanding night for the youngster.
First and 10, ASU, 16-yard line of the Air Force. Tailback is still Winsley. There he is. But only a yard. This
Winsley, the ball carrier.
Three of the Falcons, led by Kevin Hughes, number 56. Passing for Daniel Ford, 14 of 27, 250 yards, a TD, and an interception. It'll be second down, 9. We're into the fourth quarter, for those of you who may have been joining us. We're at the fourth annual Freedom Bowl in Anaheim. 27-14, Sun Devils leading. The Air Force scored first. Two wide receivers to the right of quarterback Ford. Winsley, good move. Did I see a flag on the way on that run? Yes.
Yes, you did.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be a holding call and, again, take away another touchdown from Arizona State.
There it is. So instead of a 15-yard touchdown run for Winsley, who's very, very strong, he took Kevin Hughes with him.
5'5", 190. There he is. Look at the thickness of his body. He's got tremendous thighs and great hind quarters. Now watch the run. Now watch the move he puts on the cornerback. Little misdirection play. You start to the right. You hand it back to him. Look at the move right there. You can't see real good, and he gets right by the. He's dragging 56. Kevin Hughes, a 230 pounder, and he's into the end zone. If he was 6 foot, he'd have been in there with no problem. But at 5'5", you got to stretch.
So the penalty will move the ball back to the 25-yard line. Second down.
Second and 19.
13:33 left to play in the game. To the air. There was a misread by somebody. Tony Johnson was down in the end zone, but he was pretty well covered.
Ford took a shot. He's getting up awful slow, and I think the reason the ball looked so bad was the pressure put on. He wanted to go to Aaron Cox on a little comeback inside, a little spin around, and right down the line of scrimmage towards the center, but the ball was thrown actually nowhere.
And the reason, Chad Hennings again, putting on pressure.
I'll tell you, that Hennings is as good a defensive player as the Freedom Bowl has ever seen. There's no question. It's obvious why he won the Outland Trophy.
Third down, 19. Sensed a possible blitz, and there's going to be a delay of game penalty here.
You're absolutely right. He saw Mike Gant, the strong safety, sneak up a couple of steps. When he did, he immediately suspected a safety blitz. He audibilized, putting his backs in position to pick up the blitzing backs, but that took a little bit too much time.
One of our important technicians of our Ms. Lou crew, Hal Bassett, has a birthday today, but we found out that his dad, Harold, is recovering from back surgery in the San Jose Hospital. So, needless to say, in behalf of Hal, we wish him well. Well, another 5-yard penalty, so now it's third and 24 at the 30-yard line of the Air Force. Aaron Cox at the 17-yard line. Now, he was perhaps was just thinking strictly in terms of let's get it in close enough for Zendejas, because he was 11 yards shy of a first down.
But great execution, though. Yeah. I mean, that's one of the better, that's one problem that Daniel Ford has had all year. He's been hot and cold on that last play. You can't draw it up and execute it any better. A nice job of dropping back, finding his receiver, and bringing him back to the sideline.
Zendejas. 33 and 34 yard attempt.
Lost
at the holder. I snap by Grant, but it is not good. Zendejas, who had only missed 2 of 15 coming into the game, is 2 of 4 here this evening. So the score remains 27-14, Arizona State leading. And we'll be back at Anaheim right after these messages. We knew Rock would find himself in that situation before this evening was over.
Only a matter of time, Ray. Only a matter of time.
First and 10 Air Force, their own 20, down by 13. They keep trying that first man through, in this case, Roberts or Smith. That was Andy Smith. But that's the one play off this wishbone that the Sun Devils have done a good job defensively.
Excellent job, and you credit the interior line of Arizona State, Mark Duckins and Sate Sapolo, who will play that nose position, doing a super job. The inside backers of Drew Metcalf and Mark Kinstead, outstanding performance inside for Arizona State.
Gain of 3, second down, second. Fake to the full. Keep to the 28. It will be third down and 2. On me here that Steve Letnich, his backup tonight, Lance McDowell, and Dee Dallas, who broke the record for quarterbacks rushing in a season, all three are sophomores. So this tells us something about the future at that position, at the very least, for the Air Force next year.
The Air Force Academy quarterback has always had to be a great athlete because so much is expected of him. Somebody will be moved, no question, next year, I would think.
2 yards needed for first down. Oh, boy. Absolutely nothing for Roberson. Trace Armstrong was there.
He's upset. Anthony Roberson a little bit upset. Thought he should have got a little bit more than he did, but good defense again by Arizona State.
Dwayne King was also in on the play. Nathan LeDuc back for the kick by Blasey. 11:40 to play in the game. Air Force has not been able to score in the second half. The Sun Devils have had a field goal here in the second half. Short punt again. LeDuc at his own 40. Gets it to the 49-yard line. A 31-yard punt. An 8-yard return. Where Faison made the tackle for the Air Force Academy. We'll return to Anaheim after these messages. ASU, great position, their own 49, first and 10. Grant snaps, forward to Williams. This running attack of the Sun Devils, as far as yardage is concerned, has to be closing in on the yardage for the Air Force tonight. And the Air Force came into the game averaging just under, we have a player injured for ASU. Air Force came into the game averaging 386 yards a game.
Rushing, that's unbelievable. That's as much as most teams average total offense.
Channing Williams limping slightly. I imagine we'll see number 20, Kirk Wendorf, junior from Granada Hills, California, replacing.
Just under 700 yards on the season, an outstanding game tonight. As usual, always plays an outstanding game, does Channing Williams.
The gain, about 8. Second down, 2:44 of the Air Force. Fake to the tailback. There is the tight end, Knutson, and that's a first down at the 34-yard line. Knutson from Edmonds, Washington, didn't catch very many passes this season, but he's having a good game tonight.
Absolutely correct. He only had 17 receptions for 174 yards and one touchdown, but did catch one TD. 36 yards has been his longest reception of the year. A nice one on that last play by the tight end, Gary Knutson.
Wendorf stays in at fullback. Winsley comes back in at tailback. A first and 10 play. Whoa! Winsley ran into Derek. No, that was Kenny Jabadlo. Just came into the game, an Arlington Heights, Illinois sophomore. No gain. In fact, lost about a yard. Second down, 11. Time is ticking away here in the fourth quarter of the fourth annual Freedom Bowl. 10:25 remaining. Sun Devils lead by 13 points, 27-14. Big hole for Winsley. Good moves. That's a gain of about 15, 14 yards, let's call it.
Very, very quick, Ray. Quick feet. Watch him as he runs right at you, but a good job by Andrew Toth, the cornerback for the Air Force Academy. Bus out, look at that. Into the hole, good move, but watch Toth stands right there, squares up, does a good job of squaring up, making the tackle. Otherwise, a touchdown for the young David Winsley.
First and 10, 20-yard line of the Air Force. And that Sun Devil's size and strength of the offensive line. There goes Wendell. He is good speed. And the Sun Devils score a TD. A 20-yard run, and Ford is down and hurt. The quarterback took quite a lick.
He's getting up slow.
Yes, he is.
He's looking at the official. What he's saying is, hey, why don't you call a penalty on that? That's a late hit. Let's see if he is hit late. A nice inside handoff to number 20, Kirk Wendorf. Now watch the block up top of 84, Aaron Cox on 26, Andrew Toth, which allows him to get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona State. Is he happy or not? Yes, he is.
Garrett will be the holder now instead of Ballstead for his Endejas extra point attempt. The first extra point miss by Zendejas this season. So it is now Arizona State 33, the Air Force 14, and we'll be right back after these messages. Zendejas, who just missed his first extra point of the season, will be kicking off to either Faison or Roberson. ASU 197 total yards versus 57 for the Air Force. Here's Roberson. Out to the 33-yard line.
Watch Todd Kalish. He's the offensive guard who's going to get a block, but I think on this one we're going to see the quarterback, Daniel Ford, take a shot by Randall Gladney. The boom right there. Look at that. Now you know why he gets upset. Look at the block here at 65. Todd Kalish right there on 54. Rip Bergwall. A nice job of blocking. A huge hole for Kirk Wendorf. And that's the reason he gets a touchdown along with an outstanding block downfield by Aaron Cox.
51 yards in five plays. First down Air Force now. Air Force on the 10-yard line. Oh, here's the new quarterback, McDowell. Lance McDowell. Very close to a first down. A sophomore from Shreveport, Louisiana. Replacing Steve Lepnich.
Well, they're going to give him a shot. 5'8", 166-pound sophomore. Has not thrown a pass this year. Has rushed five times for 31 yards. They're going to see if he can generate a little enthusiasm into this Air Force offense. Give him a shot to see what he can do.
ASU has held the Air Force scoreless here in the second half. McDowell got the first down at the 43 of the Air Force. And there's about another 10-yard gain, this time by Quentin Roberts, the senior fullback from Lansing, Michigan. That might be another first down.
Well, we've seen that play so many times, and Arizona State has stopped it, but that's the problem with the bone. You can't stop it every single time, and it's going to be, I think, close enough for a first down measure.
He's back in the game now at a linebacker spot in place of Dwayne King, a freshman who has been playing at that position. And it is short by about a foot.
To see if they will let this youngster try and throw a pass. He has not passed this year. Lance McDonald, a new quarterback for Air Force, maybe a little play action, take it to that fullback, come back
back out and try and zip it into somebody, or were they just going to keep it on the ground and try and pick up the first down?
Whatever he's going to do has been carried in by Tyler Barth, the leading receiver for the Air Force. Tomorrow night, the Blue Bonnet Bowl from Houston, Texas. First down and more at the 38-yard line of ASU. Quick feet owned by Lance McDowell.
Starts that motor there, Lance. Yes, let's get going. Big first down for the Air Force Academy. A little side. He's been watching too much of the NFL. He's getting a little bit of that to the right and a little bit of that to the left there.
8:37 left to play in the game. Out to the left to Steve Sen, the sophomore wide receiver from Albuquerque. Go to the air, take to the full. Oh, my goodness. That was Mark Duckett's. Rock wrote. Are you still shivering down there in the sidelines?
Well, I at least have one hand in my pocket that's warm. I tell you, these fans are having a tough time staying warm, but these Air Force fans are hanging in with their team. This is the Colas family, Judy Colas and her two daughters. How do you guys feel? Obviously, the Air Force is down right now.
We're with them all the way.
Now, you've had a 9-3 season. Obviously, you've been hanging with them all the way through.
That's right, and we're here tonight.
All right, they're here. They're cold, but they're hanging in there. Back to you, Ray and Jack.
Second and 13 after Duckett sacked McDowell at the 41-yard line of Arizona State. Fake to the full. Oh, what a hole. McDowell got about 10 yards back. So there, set up a third down and between 3 and 4. Midway fourth quarter, 7:30 to play, clock running. Arizona State fell behind 7-0. Tied it up, went ahead, led at the half, 24-14. Added a field goal, and a touchdown run by second string fullback Kirk Wendorf. Third down and about 4. Give to the full. Short of the first down is Quinton Roberts. Coaches to know, let's go for it.
Yeah. Well, they're in fourth down. There's no sense in going to a field goal, but they're going to have to go for it here on fourth down.
A little more, about a yard and a half to go for a first down.
Let's see if he keeps it like he did last time. Picked up about, 10 or 12 in the last tackle on the first down.
Barth is coming out to the left. Whoop. Saw something he didn't like, so the Air Force will have to use one of its 3 allotted timeouts with 6:20 to play in the game. The scoreboard reading 33-14 in favor of the Arizona State Sun Devils, and we're going to come back here after these words from your local station.
And he flicks that ball before he takes a shot, shoots it out to Roberson, who gets by the first tackler, picks up the first down before he's brought down by 3 Arizona State.
First and 10, Arizona State 26, 6 minutes to play in the game. But 3 yards a carry won't do it at this stage. Mark Tingstad made the tackle.
They will allow that, Arizona State defensively. They'll say, sure, go ahead. You just keep coming off with that bone. We'll give up 3, 4, 5, 6 yards a pop because it's going to take you a long time to get down and score. And when you're down by 19 points, that's exactly what you're doing. You're playing into the hands of the defense.
Second down 7, 23-yard line of Arizona State. The right corner is playing well off Barth, the wide receiver down there. Now we'll get gets to the 20. It'll set up a third down and four.
Man, Pat Taylor's again in on the tackle. Watching Lance McDowell. Let's see if the hole opens up and if, how quickly it closes. There's a hole right there. Look at that. Looks like you drive a truck through, and then all of a sudden, whammo, there they come. Five Arizona State Sun Devils.
Taylor followed by Metcalf and friends. Third down, four, Arizona State 20. Sen goes out to the right. Draws the attention of cornerback Eric Allen. Whoop. I thought I'd see a flag there. I thought I saw Blake Geddes, the center, actually leave and then sort of reach back and snap the ball. But obviously I was wrong. Sean Patterson made the defensive play. That's 13 consecutive, what you, I think you would really call conservative running plays.
Yeah, they want to, I think what Fisher DeBerry would like to do now would be definitely get some more points on the scoreboard. They're down by 19, and 33-21 looks a lot better than 33-14.
Fourth down and two at the 18-yard line of Arizona State. 4 minutes to play in the game. That'll stop the clock while they move the chains. The ball at the 13-yard line of Arizona State.
Another good size hole open up on the right side. Terry Carr in there doing some fine job of blocking, and there's Roberts, Quentin Roberts. Again, remember, not a big guy, 5'7", 181 pounds, and he's the fullback.
3:45 and the clock running. A three-yard pickup for Albert Hooker. He already has scored a touchdown tonight, one of the two recorded by the Air Force Falcons under Fisher DeBerry. A junior from South Carolina. Greg Johnson, who scored the other touchdown, replaces Booker now. Johnson, number 40. Second down, 7 yards needed for a first down, 10 yards needed for an Air Force touchdown. Kate throw, all alone, that's an Air Force touchdown. 10-yard toss. And Steve Senn was on the receiving end.
A nice job by Steve Senn and Lance McDowell. Now McDowell looks like he's going to throw it. He feels the pressure. Great job of composure until his receiver, Steve Senn, comes wide open in the end zone. Good concentration by Steve Senn. Makes a catch. Touchdown. Another look at it right here. He's rolling out. You'll see Steve Senn break wide open in the end zone. He was working on Eric Allen. Gets wide open. Nice job. The official was so surprised he fell down, too, to get out of the way.
33-20, and the Air Force will go for two. With 2:59 left to play in the game, they'll have their other wide receiver. Barth and Sen have been the only wide receivers used. What have we here? Rehuddle by the Air Force Falcons. McDowell's first pass.
7 yards and 13 plays.
He certainly did.
Fullback does not get the two-point conversion. So, 2:59 remaining. There'll be a kickoff to the Sun Devils by the Air Force. That will come right after these messages. Proud television sponsor of both the Winter and Summer Olympics and tonight's Freedom Bowl. No matter where you want to fly, chances are Northwest Airlines can get you there. I'm going to tell you what else is on my mind. Rick Cahoon is down at the 33-yard line. We want to show you that touchdown again.
Lance McDowell, watch him put a little fake pass and Pat Taylor, number 51, on the left side of your screen. Now watch the fake. Now watch Taylor go up in the air trying to block it. See right there, and he pulls it down. A good job by the youngster, Lance McDowell. Here comes Steve Senn across left to right. Gets wide open. He beats 25, Eric Gallen. He keeps after it. 13 plays, 67 yards, 6 minutes and 45 seconds.
And a few more words from Northwest Airlines right now as the Sun Devils aren't quite ready with their offensive unit. We want to tell you that Northwest flies all over the world to over 200 cities in 20 countries on three continents. So when you need to fly, look to us. Now, we have a lot of changes here. A lot of changes here for the Sun Devils. A new quarterback, Paul Justin, a freshman from Schaumburg, Illinois. Wendorf is the fullback. He's had quite a bit of playing time. This is from the ASU 33-yard line. This is Wendorf, good speed, but he can't get outside for more than a yard. Now, you're going to see number 71, Doug Larson. He has played briefly tonight when McDaniel moved from guard to fullback in a short yardage situation. We have a huge right tackle, Michael Simmons, from Tulsa, Oklahoma, freshman, who goes around 300 plus.
328 to be exact.
And I'll tell you, that might be a little conservative. And I'm going to try and get all the names of these players in here of both teams who have not had a chance to play before right now. That play gained a yard by Wendell. Second and nine, ASU 34, 2:14 to play in the game. There's Vic Cahoon. Good game by the freshman from Manassas, Virginia, Vic Cahoon, number 31. He picked up about 7 yards. It'll be third and two at the Sun Devil 41-yard line.
He took a shot, too. He's kind of breathing deep, sucking it up. You look at Justin. He has started before. He started the Washington game, Ray, as you well know, and he had a rough outing at the outset, but they project him to be a good quarterback for Arizona State in the future.
Now, Lynn James, number 18, is a wide receiver. It's the first time we've seen this sophomore from Navasota, Texas. Third and two. Whoop, flag down. Could that be delay of game?
I think you're right. I think the clock ran out.
Another new offensive lineman in there. Wait a minute. Mark Hayes is listed as a defensive lineman. Unless he changed numbers, number 73 is in there.
Another small freshman tackle, 6'7", 260, Mark Hayes.
From San Diego. After the 5-yard penalty for delay of game, it is third and six at the ASU 36. A minute and a half remaining. Cahoon. Within a yard of a first down at the 42-yard line, it'll bring up a fourth down. We'd like to let you know of the people who are involved in sending this game your way. Our executive producer is Vic Piano. Coordinating producer, Bob Davis, our producer, Roger Swing, our director, and I'm sorry, I missed one of those names there. Bill Swing is the executive in charge of production. I knew that. Stan Leshner is our technical manager. Mobile unit supplied by MDC Productions. And our thanks to two longtime friends of ours, our spotter, Chuck Panama, and to our statistician, whom there is no better. To say that about both Chuck and our statistician, Dennis Munition. It's time for Mike Shue. I think this is his first punt of the second half, if I'm not mistaken, Jack.
I think you're right.
Mike Shue, one of the finest punters in college football. Tyler Barr is back at the 20-yard line of the Air Force with a minute and 21 seconds left. And the Sun Devils leading by 33-20. In the finale, as the head coaching, in the head coaching spot at Arizona State, the finale for John Cooper, headed for Columbus, Ohio. Is Barth. Gets it from the 10 out to about the 17. Most valuable player for Arizona State, quarterback Daniel Ford. Most valuable player for the Air Force Academy, guess who? Chad Hennings.
Two good choices. Two very, very good choices. Both have had outstanding games all season long, and they have had an outstanding night tonight.
The young man who replaced Letnich at quarterback, another sophomore, Shreveport, Louisiana's Lance McDowell, who threw his first pass, and it was for a touchdown. Ford, 16 of 30, 272 yards, a touchdown. That was to Aaron Cox, and he was intercepted one time. This is McDowell setting up a screen. Oh, this is a new running back. the clock around the 33-yard line. That was number 32, Robert Krause, a junior from Greenwood, Indiana. That was his first play of the evening. Now we have another. You sure get him in here.
Robert Krause, we may add also, is that that was his first reception of 1987.
Ted Pesh-Ahonis. From Paducah, Kentucky. Kentucky is in the game. There goes McDowell. Boy, he is quick. That's about a first down around the 43-yard line of the Air Force. Just under a minute to play.
Bob Frankel comes in there, a late replacement for Arizona State, playing at the nose guard position. 6'5", 254-pound junior out of British Columbia, Canada.
Rasp, number 78, a freshman from McKeesport, Pennsylvania, is also in defensively now.
McDowell had Blanchard in the slot. Len Blanchard just kind of bounced off his shoulder pad. There you see McDowell, something's wrong with his shoulder pads. He wants a timeout to get them straightened out. They've come loose. So one of the sure-handed offensive linemen who will probably be a surgeon someday, Blake Geddes, comes in there and ties it up for him.
Blanchard is a sophomore from San Antonio, Texas. Second down 10 at the 43 of the Air Force with 52 seconds remaining. Dowell. The young man whose name I had difficulty pronouncing.
I think that's Krause again, Ray.
Was that Krause that time?
Yeah.
Oh, that was Krause that time.
That's his second catch of 1987. He's saving him for the big ball game for the Freedom Bowl.
All right, I was thinking of number 22, the Paducah, Kentucky junior, Ted Pesh-Ahonis. Needless to say, among others interested in John Cooper's situation, moving to Ohio State would be his assistants on the staff. This is a third and sixth play. Did he get the ball? No, not out of bounds. 2 yards shy of a first down, did Lance McDowell. It's going to be fourth down, 43 seconds remaining. ASU led at the half 24-14. We had just 3 points scored in the third period, a field goal by Allenson Dejas, 6 points scored by ASU in the fourth quarter, and that was matched by the Air Force with 6 points. Fourth and 2.5, 49-yard line of ASU. McDowell has the first down. He stops the clock. Fields, a freshman from South Holland, Illinois, number 24, is in the secondary for Arizona State.
McDowell hobbling back to the huddle. It looks like he may have injured or twisted that right ankle a little bit going out of bounds, but he won't come out. This is his opportunity. He's going to stay with it.
Shane Collins, a freshman linebacker, number 83, from Bozeman, Montana, is getting a chance to play for a bit here for Arizona State. Going for the end zone. Oh, boy. Krause again.
Yeah.
I tell you, that McDowell has a strong arm.
He does have a strong arm, just a little bit too much time before he released the ball. But good strong arm. Krause was open, had two or three steps on the defender. But by the time, here it is right here, we'll get a good shot. Lacey, he's got about a step and a half, 2 steps on the defender, but the ball hangs up there a little bit long. Too long. It looks like it's going to be intercepted, then caught for a touchdown, but as they come down, neither one can hold on. Incompletion.
Nathan LeDuc doing a good job defending against Krause. Second down 10. 30 seconds left. Tyler Barth, and he came into the game, was the Air Force's leading receiver. That was an 18-yard gain. And
left foot's down. Left foot's down. Great call by the official. That's true. A good call. He was inbounds. Very close, but he was.
That play took 6 seconds. We still have 24 seconds remaining. Sun Devils by Bert Keene. Could get.
He was looking everywhere. Where can I go? He started out to his left, turned it back upfield, looked around, said, well, I'm going to cut it back to the right side. He looked back, and then, wow, there's about two or three big ones. There he is. There's number seven for Arizona State. Fine quarterback had an outstanding night, Daniel Ford.
Mike Rast made the defensive play for Arizona State. We want to tell you about some more people who are involved in our telecast this evening. Way through the list a little while ago. Gary Metz and video, Fred Aldis and Greg Harriman are audio. Familiar names. And let's see if I can pick out some more players here. Dwayne King is back into the linebacking spot for Arizona State.
Be a big plus for the Falcons of the Air Force Academy if they can push across a touchdown right here. There's 16 seconds left to go in the ball game. They're down by 13. If they can score right here, draw closer yet, be very respectable for the Academy. They should be very proud of themselves.
Leland Adams is in for Arizona State in the secondary. 16 seconds to go. Second and seven. Air Force inside the Arizona State 20. McDowell, who is throwing a touchdown pass, and there's another one. There is another one. This one is to Steve Senn. And I'll tell you, Lance McDowell's got to be making points with that coaching staff here with his performance.
Absolutely. A nice job by the youngster McDowell.
So with 10 seconds remaining, the score changes to 33-26.
Short roll out to his left, a deep square in by Steve Senn. He makes a nice leaping catch. So watch him jump right into the end zone. Excellent job by both quarterback McDowell and receiver Steve Senn. Another look, a short roll to the left. He's going to look back across field. He's staying with Senn all the way on a square in. Senn goes up, cradles the ball to his body to make sure it's not knocked down, crosses into the end zone, touchdown the Air Force.
So the second time the Air Force has gone for a two-point conversion, the first time they were stopped. Score changes to 33-28, and we'll be right back after these messages. With 10 seconds left, there's the attempt at the onside kick, and Aaron Cox has it at the 48-yard line of the Air Force. Of course, you know that John Cooper and staff had people in there that are used to handling the football. Defensive backs, receivers, running backs, and Aaron Cox, who had a fine, fine effort tonight in his final game in a Sun Devil uniform, recovers the ball with the clock showing 4 seconds remaining. And Daniel Ford will handle the snap. He was replaced the last time Arizona State had the football by freshman Paul Justin. But Daniel Ford, our game's MVP for Arizona State, will be the quarterback on what, barring a penalty, will be the final play of the game.
And I would venture a guess that he will take a knee as soon as the ball has been snapped.
Yep. There it is. The Air Force had no timeouts remaining. And the Sun Devils give head coach John Cooper a present on his final game coaching Arizona State University. Final score, Arizona State 33, Air Force Academy 28. We'll be right back to Anaheim after these messages.